We see many of the offers. Why before release of a movie, those movie stars, they come to different reality show to promote their movies. Why we see that there is an offer buy two get seven free. What are those things? And why those companies they do such things? Because it is all about your promotional strategy, where company needs to do when to promote, where to promote, how to promote, and how many times to promote, because it really makes that company to survive in the market for the longer period of time. It is the strategy through which a company counter the attack from its competitors. So to explore all those things, we have with us very young and dynamic marketing shark, marketing mind, Dr. Anshuman Jena. Let's explore all those things about promotional strategies with Dr. Anshuman Jena. So, Dr. Jena, it is now over to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir, for the kind words and warm introduction. Let me start my presentation by welcoming all our learners, those who have joined today. I believe they have been experiencing some change due to the change of the policies regarding the lockdown. And we might have noticed the strategy behind the state government as well as the central government, the way they are announcing the lockdown, the way they are communicating or informing the progress they have made with regard to various decisions, the way they are engaging. They are also explaining what is the status, how many individuals, how many districts, how many cities, and how many countries are affected by this COVID-19 and its impact. Therefore, possibly the citizens are not only getting the information at the right time, but they are also getting some time to prepare themselves mentally and physically. So this is about the government machinery communicating to people, the citizens. So does this kind of communication is different as compared to the marketing communication when a company is trying to communicate or engage with the customers? No, it is not. Is it different or is it absolutely unique the way we communicate as individuals, as society, as a part of a village or city or town? Yes, it is slightly different, but it is still based on the same principle, same philosophy that governs the basic communication machinery. So we will discuss about promotion decisions from communication perspective. How information is being shared, why it is shared, and it is shared among whom, who are the beneficiaries, who is communicating, at what point of time, and with what frequency. And we will also talk about, or we'll also discuss about, what are the corresponding impact of such communication. And of course, our discussion will broadly be confined to companies or business or marketing communication. However, we will also discuss about contemporary issues, challenges that not only the companies, not only the government, but the citizens are facing at present, and that is the pandemic COVID-19. So let us first discuss briefly what we have discussed so far. We have discussed important concepts of marketing. We have discussed about marketing environment. We have discussed about buyer behavior buyer decision making process. We have also discussed about market segmentation, targeting, positioning strategies. We have also discussed about product mix, pricing, distribution decisions and strategies. We have also discussed new product development strategies and PLC, product lifecycle. Right. So we have discussed broadly the three P's out of the four P's of marketing mix. We have discussed product, we have discussed price, we have discussed place or distribution. So today's discussion is broadly based on the fourth P, that is promotion, or we can say marketing communication. So here, I'm not sure up to what extent we'll be covering today based on the SLM that is meant for all of you. This is what the entire block consists of: marketing communication, what is integrated marketing communication, types and tools of marketing communication like advertising, sales, public relation, personal selling, and emerging issues. So let us see up to what extent we are able to cover today. So maybe yes, this is the communication process, a simple diagram which you might have gone through career as a student or learner or practitioner. So this talks about the relationship between the message, the media, sender, receiver, and it depicts the entire communication process, how encoding happens, how decoding happens. Right. So marketing communication means it is the attempt by the company to persuade, to inform, to remind the customers directly or indirectly about the products and brands they sell. It also includes the value propositions offered by the company or by the brand. That is what marketing communication is, and that is slightly different than business communication or interpersonal communication. It has a specific objective. The specific objective of marketing communication is to provide information about the brand or the product or the value proposition to the customers or to the potential customers so that they are either informed, persuaded, or reminded about all these things. And when we are talking about positioning strategies, marketing communication plays a critical role, a crucial role in creating a distinct brand image as well as long-term positioning of the brand. We'll get into the details of the marketing communication process and the impact. So what are the tools for marketing communication? It is advertising, sales promotion, events and experiences, public relations, publicity, direct marketing, interactive marketing, word of mouth marketing, personal selling. So these are broadly the tools available for marketing communications. Maybe advertising, sales promotion are the age old and the most popular promotional tools or marketing communication tools adopted by almost every company. There are several companies, those who are extensively using interactive marketing strategies or like social media, internet, and all other digital technology. There are companies, those who are extensively using direct marketing or personal selling. We'll discuss each of these tools with their advantages and limitations, along with we'll discuss about practical examples where companies are using these kind of strategies. Now, let us try to understand the same communication model, but from a marketer's perspective, how relevant it is for the marketers. You see, the same diagram has been divided into two fields. One field talks about the sender's experience, another sphere or field talks about the receiver's experience. In marketing communication, mostly the sender is the company or the brand or the advertiser. But who are the receivers? The receivers are the customers or the potential customers or the audience at large or the stakeholders at large. Right. So here we are going to understand how the sender's influence or experience influences the receiver's experience and how that communication results in brand building and positioning. So when we're talking about communication process, there are three broad issues related to it. One is selective attention, then selective distortion, then selective retention. Let us understand each of these terms or aspects. What is selective attention? As the name suggests, we as human beings, we only pay attention to specific things based on our choices or likings or dislikings. Just imagine, let's say you are traveling from your home to your workplace or to your university or institution. You might come across a number of hoardings, posters, advertisements, people, shops, showrooms, you know, many signage. A lot of information will come across when you are traveling from point A to point B. We don't remember everything. We only remember things, those who matter to us. Like if you are interested in, let's say, cinemas, movies, music. So if you see a hoarding or if you come across a hoarding that talks about or that is related to that field, you might remember what was the message or at least the name of the cinema or whatever, right? But we tend to forget other things. So that is selective retention. When we remember certain things and we forget other things, so we retain some part of the information, not the entire part of it. So that is selective retention. Selective attention means there are certain things which attract our attention. Let's say if somebody is a vegetarian and if he or she comes across the advertisement of KFC, Kentucky Fried Chicken, or McDonald's, where they are highlighting some non-veg product. So he or she might not pay that much of attention. He or she will just look at it and he or she finds there is no value, no interest of that particular individual in accordance to the marketing communication or the product or brand that has been offering. So they might not pay proper attention, but you know, they might not go through the entire print ad or the television ad. But if somebody is a lover of chicken or fried chicken or who is a fan of KFC as a brand, so he or she might consider watching the entire ad. He or she might also go through, if it is a printed ad, he or she might also go through the fine details, each and every word, try to figure out where the store is located, what is the price, what is the offer, up to what extent or what is the timeline to avail the offer. That is selective attention. We pay attention to specific things based on our requirement, based on our likes and dislikes. But out of whatever we get or as inputs or as stimuli, we retain some part of it. We only remember some part of it. Maybe if you try to figure out what was the last KFC ad you have seen, you might not remember each and every detail. You might remember possibly the logo of KFC, the Colonel's image, red color, maybe some chicken pieces, and maybe that price or some offer. So that is selective retention, but the advertisement might have contained a lot of information other than what you remember. So that is selective retention. And what is selective distortion? Selective distortion talks about when there are missing pieces of information, or the information is hazy or fuzzy. Then people create their own narrative to suit their interest. For example, let's say you don't remember what was the price, but you remember there was some kind of offer, or you do not know what was the last date to up to what the offer was valid. So when you go to the outlet and you ask for that particular offer or benefit, if the person says, the offer was till last Sunday, it is Tuesday today, and the offer is not valid. So you might say, either willingly, if you know it or you remember it, or you might say out of your ignorance or part of your memory corruption or lack of information, that I have read in the newspaper or I have seen in the television commercial that it is valid for the entire month of June. So how can you deny me providing that benefit? So that is a part of, selective distortion. You don't have that information clearly. You don't remember the instance or the offer or specific details of the information, but you try to, build your narrative that suits your purpose. That is selective distortion. You might also do not remember what is the exact color of the SLM, cover page of the SLM. Or what kind of image is given on the first page? If you have to, if somebody asks, just draw what is the or how the first page or the cover page of your SLM looks like, you might not be able to portray all those information absolutely correctly. But there, selective attention, you might have noticed the logo, placement of logo, where the block unit is or the, the course code, program code is mentioned. You might get some information, out of your memory. That is selective retention. But you might add something to it or some other information which you think should have been there or might be there based on your own interpretation. So you might end up adding certain things, right? So these three things are to be taken into consideration while designing or while formulating the marketing communication process. Why? Because if we know what our target group of customers like about, or what kind of information or what kind of approach will be suitable to gather their or to attract their attention or to divert their attention. Remember, friends, that we are living in an information age where we are bombarded and we are continuously bombarded with information. It is very difficult for us to remember each and every information that we come across, whether it is related to advertisement or marketing communication, whether it is what we talk with our friends, what we talk with our family members, what we discuss with, while we are traveling in a public transport to a fellow passenger. It can be any discussion, right? So these things are to be carefully crafted and carefully designed by the marketing professionals or advertisers so that the advertisement or the marketing communication process catches the attention and it helps them retain the information. Like, let me give you some examples here. Like, we still remember the Pappu Pass Ho Jayega, sorry, Pappu Pass Ho Gaya campaign from Cadbury Dairy Milk. We still know or remember 2 minutes means Maggie, or you know, that is almost synonymous. We know several brands, several companies, and that is how they have positioned themselves in our mind. They have communicated properly. They have not only caught our attention, they have successfully helped us retain specific and useful information about them. And there is, if the communication is effective, then there will be no scope for selective distortion. But it never happens. So we'll discuss all these impacts on crafting promotion strategies subsequently. Then let us talk about marketing communication mix. Like we know, mix means it is a combination. So marketing communication mix is a combination of different marketing communication tools like advertising, sales promotion, personal selling, public relation, and other interactive tools. That is marketing communication mix. So today, and here from here, we'll go into integrated marketing communication. Integrated marketing communication talks about carefully integrating all the communication channels to deliver a clear, consistent, and compelling message about the company, about the brand, about the value proposition offered by the brand. Right. So let us discuss this diagram first. Like you see, there are various marketing strategies or tools for communication available. So based on the available tools, the marketing strategies or the brand managers or the marketing managers, they need to decide which type of it is. Let's say it is like a war where you need to know when and up to what extent or at what time you are going to use your air force, when you are going to deploy your navy and army, up to what extent, how many soldiers, how many troopers, what kind of artillery they are going to use, and so on. It is also, another analogy could be, it is also very similar to cooking, preparing a dish. Ultimate success of the dish is it has to be good looking, it has to be tasty, and it has to be healthy. And there are several ingredients the individuals or chefs or cooks or our in our household, some of our family members, they use. So it has to be a perfect blend of or combination of those ingredients. The blend is much more or equally important as compared to the selection of the elements. जो एलिमेंट गुड़ा को आमे यूज करिबा, जो उपादान गुड़ी को आमे यूज करिबा, जो टूल्स आमे यूज करिबा, सेटा भी इम्पोर्टेंट, आउ से टूल बा से उपादान बा से प्रोसेस टा भी सेतिकि इम्पोर्टेंट, से कॉम्बिनेशन टा भी सेतिकि इम्पोर्टेंट, अदरवाइज जदि आमे रॉन्ग टूल यूज करचंती, दैट माइट आल्सो रिजल्ट इन फेलियर, इफ वी आर अडॉप्टिंग ए पुअर यू नो कॉम्बिनेशन, that might also lead to failure. So crafting the marketing communication mix strategy is a very, very tricky task for the marketing managers, because ultimately the success or the failure largely depend on the marketing communication process, because here we are taking the brand or the company or the value proposition or the reputation of the company to the actual users or to the end users. That is why marketing communication matters most when it is in the old era or when it is in the contemporary time. So here, why we need to adopt integrated marketing communication? These days, use of these tools or multiple tools has been prominent in case of any or many brands, many companies. Right. So here, there has to be one voice, one message, and one strategy. It should not be like our advertising strategy is talking about something else, our sales promotion strategy is talking about something else, and our public relation, direct marketing, integrative, it's like, imagine your body. So everything, when you wake up in the morning, when you want to go to the toilet or to another room, or even you want to get up, you need all your organs help each other, coordinate with each other to achieve that task. But imagine your left hand is going somewhere else, your left foot, right foot, they are moving in other directions, and you are thinking about something else, your eyes are closed, and you want to walk or run, then you are either going to fall or you are most likely not going to achieve what you want to achieve. So that is the core mantra of integrated marketing communication. One voice, one message, one strategy. Across all the promotional tools, whether it is advertising, sales promotion, and whatever, or social media marketing, so there has to be one voice, one message, and one strategy. And that is the principle or the mantra of integrated marketing communication. It minimizes conflicting messages from different sources so that the customers, the target audiences, they are not confused. And they have a clear understanding of the real value, real image of the brand or company. So that is why integrated marketing communication strategy is adopted by almost every company at present. There cannot be a single marketing mix or a single marketing communication strategy. So why IMC? Why, other than this one message, one voice and one strategy, there are other aspects of integrated marketing communication being so popular these days. First one is decreasing impact of advertising. We know how many channels are there. Let us first talk about television channels or television medium. Out of those channels, there are many genres. There are sports channels, there are English news channels, there are Hindi news channels, there are regional news channels, there are regional entertainment channels, Hindi entertainment channels, and so on. Movies, cinema, and music, lifestyle, sports, all those things are there. Kids channels are also there. Cooking channels are also there. There are religious channels, and so on. Many companies, they advertise on all these multiple genres. But with a single press of the remote button, the customer can, or the potential customer or the viewer of that particular channel, they can easily switch the channel and skip the ad. Like while watching on YouTube, you can simply skip an ad or most of the ads, right? So there, the customer is sufficiently at present, the customer or the potential customer or the audience is sufficiently empowered to skip the marketing communication. That is why the impact of advertising is reducing. because that electronic medium or television medium has lost its original charm. I'm not saying it has got completely distorted or it is not no longer popular. It is still popular, but the kind of response it used to exert from the audiences has reduced. That is for sure. But the charm, name, fame, money, rigor, research, everything is still there. Then new ways to reach customers, like the companies can now advertise themselves or try to reach the customers through their website. You can order things from your mobile phone or for by dialing a particular number or giving a missed call. You can request a call back. So all these new ways, new mediums being popular, being adopted by companies or customers has made advertising less popular and other mediums glow and grow as well. Then demand for greater accountability. Accountability talks about fixing responsibility. Who is ultimately responsible? Can you just advertise something, anything, and you can make a false promise and get away with it? Maybe that was possible in the very nascent era of advertising. But today, a customer or any viewer, they can raise a complaint if the advertisement or if the communication or if the promises made by the company or made by the brand are misleading or false. They can file suit, they can file for damages and all. So here at present, the advertisers, not only the company, not only the brand, not only the shareholders of the companies, but also the advertising agency. If a particular advertising agency is responsible for designing the ad, they are also being accountable. There is a debate going on whether the celebrities endorsing a certain or some specific products or brands, should they also be accountable? Right. Let's say some celebrity during the Maggie noodles crisis, people started questioning Amitabh Bachchan because he was promoting Maggie. People started questioning sports stars or other Bollywood or Hindi cinema actors or other celebrities when there was a cola controversy. People are questioning the moral, the ethics behind promoting fairness creams. Why we need a fair skin? Is it not possible that we celebrate real beauty as it is, irrespective of the skin color? So these are greater, or let's say the sexist messages or advertisement by deo companies. No angel is going to fall if you are from the heaven, if you are using a particular brand of deodorant. It never happens and it will never happen. But a kind of impression that leaves on the customers or the buyers is long lasting. So people are actually, they are started questioning the accountability of such advertising agencies, such advertisers, such brands, such products, and they are trying to fix the companies responsible for doing all these things. Then growth of database marketing. Earlier, there was no concept of database marketing where the customers or customer relationship management, there were no customer database. And that was mostly because advertising was a kind of free run that was given to the customers, that was mostly organized, not very carefully organized by the companies or the brands. Right. So with the emergence of technology, growth of database marketing, adoption of internet, adoption of customer relationship management, change of marketing philosophy, all these, are making integrated marketing communication the most feasible communication strategy. Then the other aspects of IMC or popularity of IMC includes growth of international marketing. Most of the companies, most of the brands, they are trying to be or they are trying to become multinational companies. They want to bridge the gap between the geographic borders or different locations. So there, you cannot say that I'm going to be positioning my company, my brand in a different way in different continents. That was possible in the earlier days. But that is not possible today because when you have a website and the website is connected to internet, and people are also connected to internet. Everyone can go there, browse information like Amazon India. They have Indian version of the website, but being an Indian, staying in India, you can still visit the Amazon US website or UK website. Right. And there you see the kind of approach, the kind of strategy they are following. It is almost the same as compared to their strategy in India. So it is broadly based on the same philosophy. Of course, there will be some deviation based on the market requirements or sentiments, right? But there will be no large deviation, right? Then emphasis on relationship marketing that I have already discussed. It is related to customer relationship marketing or management, where a customer is no longer considered to be an external entity. A customer is also being involved in the product design development phase or strategy. Customers are the most valued input providers for any brand, any company. If there is a good or solid relationship established between the company and brand, then that is the most significant achievement for that company. Then tighter control over communication. Over the years, regulation or regulatory aspects related to marketing communication or advertising, this has also significantly increased. It is not only public scrutiny, but also scrutiny from the regulators. That is also trying to put the communicators, advertisers, marketing managers, or companies to be customer-centric, to not overpromise so that they cannot deliver it, to not to mislead customers through improper or misleading communication. So tighter control over communication from budgetary point of view, because communication has become very, very expensive these days. So all these things are making IMC, integrated marketing communication strategy, to be very popular and to be adopted by almost every company these days in some form or the other. So now let us see the impact of marketing communication on the brand image, brand awareness, brand response, or overall brand equity. I think this particular diagram is self-explanatory. To your left in the green circles, you see various marketing communication tools. And these tools ultimately or combined together, they form the overall marketing communication strategy of a company. That communication strategy ultimately creates the kind of brand equity that is required by the company. if at all they are successful, then the brand awareness is high, brand image is absolutely glorified, then brand response is positive, brand relationships or engagement with customer is also very, very positive and very, very encouraging, not only from the company's perspective, but also from the customer's perspective. So this diagram talks about the impact of integrated marketing communication on brand building and ultimately success of a brand or failure of a brand. If these marketing communication strategies or programs are very carelessly formulated or unscientifically formulated, they are not strategic in nature, then all these ultimately result in failure of the brand. So how these integrated marketing communication model works? So a company has its own broad objective, corporate strategy, or let's say business level strategy. Then based on that business level strategy or corporate level strategy, the marketing strategies, marketing objectives, or marketing plans are formulated. Based on the marketing objectives or marketing plans, these combination or the blend of various promotional tools are formulated so that there is a consistent, clear, and compelling message. This is a diagrammatic representation of the company's broad corporate objective, marketing objective, and based on that marketing objective, how the integrated marketing communication is formulated. This is an example, or this is a slide based on a case study, very popular case study of Pepsodent Booth Police. The objective here, let me clarify this. We know Pepsodent as a oral care brand or as a toothpaste, right? So the marketing plan or marketing objective was to make the brand very, very popular for the school-going kids, right? So what they did, how they have created this blend or mix of various communication tools. First, they came up with a, so they have created a contest. We'll discuss about that. So the objective was to encourage kids to brush teeth at night. So for that, they have created television commercials. They have created print or newspaper ads, advertisements. They have also created jingles on the Maddie Show or radio channel or talk show. They have created a contest on that. They have also created conducted awareness programs in various schools, educational institutions, so that they can highlight the benefits of oral care. They have created a specific and dedicated website where there was certain quizzes about various aspects related to oral care. Then they have collaborated with Dabbawalas in Mumbai. So this campaign was initiated or launched in Mumbai. So they have, we know the quality or the kind of reputation the Dabbawalas have, not only in Mumbai or Maharashtra, but in the entire world. They have tremendous amount of respect. So a brand like Pepsodent or Unilever or Hindustan Unilever collaborating with the Dabbawalas transfers that kind of trust, that kind of familiarity for the audience, right? So they collaborated and they communicated through the Dabbawalas to the school kids. They have also initiated a contest to write slogans or lyrics about the company, lyrics about various aspects related to oral care. And ultimately, the company or, you know, Hindustan Unilever or the campaign could successfully communicate and get 12 lakh kids to sign a pledge. माने शपथ नबा माने 12 लक्ष स्कूल पिला शपथ नेले ओरल केयर ओरल हाइजीन उपरे दैट इज ए सिग्निफिकेंट नंबर 12 लाख किड्स राइट सो व्हेन वी आर कंबाइनिंग मल्टीपल चैनल्स एंड ऑल द चैनल्स और मीडियम्स दे हैव द सेम ऑब्जेक्टिव इन माइंड एंड ऑल ऑफ देम कंट्रीब्यूट टू अचीव द सेम ऑब्जेक्टिव द आउटकम is tremendously encouraging, tremendously engaging for the customers, for the, you know, both for the audience point of view and from the company's point of view. So this is an example of integrated marketing communication strategy, and this is just one example. Almost every company is doing something similar, right? So now let us start discussing the tools one by one. So what is advertising? Advertising, we are mostly familiar with this word, maybe not the concept behind it, but we come across several ads, advertisements on various platforms or various mediums. So the technical definition of advertising or advertisement is any paid form of non-personal presentation or communication of ideas related to a particular product by an identified sponsor. Here you need to remember or focus on three four things. First, it is a paid form of communication. Mark the word paid. Then the second important aspect is non-personal presentation or non-personal communication. Then the third important aspect related to this particular definition is from an identified sponsor. So if the, you know, before discussing the technical details of it and what are the corresponding impact, let me give you one example. Let's say you are using a particular brand of mobile phone. You are very happy with it. You like the picture quality, you like the design, you like the speed, look, and you might have other reasons as well. So if one of your friends or family members or anyone who knows you tries to contact you or tries to get your suggestion about a particular brand of cell phone for his or her own use. So you might suggest the particular brand you are using or the company you are using. Right? Ame kahi pariba je eita mu use karuchi 6 mas hela ki barse hela ba bahut din hela use karuchi jete game khelile bi eta hit houni jete video dekhile bi एटा बेसी गरम होउनी आमे ताकु बैटरी बैकअप भी बहुत भलो अछि डिस्प्ले क्वालिटी बहुत भलो अछि एंड मोस्ट इम्पोर्टेंटली फ्रंट कैमरा हो सेल्फी नबा पई बा आमे एथरे जो पछपटे तीनटा कैमरा अछि कि जहां भी जेतरा कैमरा अछि आमे ताकु जेतेबेले फोटो उठौचू बा वीडियो शूट करूचू बहुत भलो क्वालिटी रो वीडियो आसुचि बा फोटो आसुचि राइट And if we are successfully communicating this and convincing the other person to purchase that particular brand, it is also a kind of communication. Ame sethi bhi communicate kale gote brand bisare, gote company bisare, and maybe se vyakti bhi seta bhala bujhile, tanku bhala lagila, and se seta kinile. So the real question is, can we call this type of communication as advertising? We cannot. That is a word of mouth communication. That is not advertisement. Because ame jo tinta keyword kahuthile, se tinta keyword is missing. Ek, you are not getting paid for that. ତମକୁ କିଛି ବା ଆପଣଙ୍କୁ କିଛି ପଇସା ମିଳିବ ନାହିଁ ଆପଣ ସେଇ ଯୋଉ ସଜେସନ୍ ଦେଲେ, ନା ସେ ଭଦ୍ର ବ୍ୟକ୍ତି ବା ଭଦ୍ର ମହିଳା ଦେବେ, ନା କମ୍ପାନୀ ବା ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ ଦେବେ ଯୋଉଟା ଆପଣ ରେକମେଣ୍ଡ କଲେ। ସୋ ଦେ ଆର୍ ନୋ ପେମେଣ୍ଟ ଇଜ୍ ହ୍ୟାପେନିଂ। ଦେନ୍ ଦ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ ଥିଙ୍ଗ, ଏଇଟା ଗୋଟେ ପର୍ସନାଲ କମ୍ୟୁନିକେସନ ଆପଣଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ ବା ମୋ ଭିତରେ, ଆଉ ମୁଁ ଯାହାକୁ ସଜେଷ୍ଟ କଲି ତାଙ୍କ ଭିତରେ, ରାଇଟ? ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ପର୍ସନାଲ କମ୍ୟୁନିକେସନ। ବଟ୍ ଦ ସେକେଣ୍ଡ କି ୱାର୍ଡ ଦ୍ୟାଟ ୱି ହ୍ୟାଭ୍ ଫୋକସ୍ଡ ଅନ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦ ଡେଫିନେସନ ଇଜ୍ ନନ୍ ପର୍ସନାଲ ପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେସନ ଅର୍ ନନ୍ ପର୍ସନାଲ କମ୍ୟୁନିକେସନ। କିନ୍ତୁ ଆମେ ଏଠି ଯୋଉ ଦେଖିଲେ ୱାର୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ମାଉଥରେ, ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ପର୍ସନାଲ କମ୍ୟୁନିକେସନ, ୱାନ୍ ଟୁ ୱାନ୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିକେସନ ଆଣ୍ଡ ମେ ବି ଟୁ ୱେ କମ୍ୟୁନିକେସନ। ସେଠି ସେ ପଚାରିବେ କେତେ ପଇସା ପଡ଼ିଲା, କୋଉଠୁ କିଣିଥିଲୁ, ଇଏମଆଇ ମିଳିବ ନା ନାହିଁ, ଆଉ କ'ଣ ତାଙ୍କର ଯଦି ଏଥିରେ ଭୋଲ୍ଟି ଫ୍ୟାସିଲିଟି ଅଛି ନା ନାହିଁ, 5G ଅଛି ନା ନାହିଁ, ଆଣ୍ଡ ସୋ ଅନ୍। ସିଏ କିଛି ବି ପଚାରିପାରନ୍ତି, ରାଇଟ? ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ଟୁ ୱେ କମ୍ୟୁନିକେସନ। ତ ସେଠି ବି ସେକେଣ୍ଡ କି ୱାର୍ଡରେ ବି ଆମେ ଏଇ ସିଚୁଏସନ୍ ଯଦି କମ୍ପେୟାର କଲେ ସେଟା ବି ମାନେ କ୍ୱାଲିଫାଏ କଲାନି। ଦେନ୍ ଦ ଥାର୍ଡ ଥିଙ୍ଗ ଇଜ୍ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଆନ୍ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଫାଏଡ୍ ସ୍ପନ୍ସର। ସ୍ପନ୍ସର କିଏ ଯିଏ ପଇସା ଦିଏ, ଏଠି ତ ପଇସା ହିଁ କିଛି କାରବାର ନାହିଁ, ବା ୟୁ ଆଜ୍ ଦ ରେକମେଣ୍ଡର ବା କମ୍ୟୁନିକେଟର ଅର୍ ସେଣ୍ଡର ଅଫ୍ ଦ ମେସେଜ, ୟୁ ଡୋଣ୍ଟ ଗେଟ୍ ଏନି, ୟୁ ଡୋଣ୍ଟ ହାଭ୍ ଏନି ରିଲେସନ୍ସିପ୍ ୱିଥ୍ ଦ କମ୍ପାନୀ ଅର୍ ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ। ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ ସହିତ, କମ୍ପାନୀ ସହିତ କିଛି ରିଲେସନ୍ ନାହିଁ ବା କୌଣସି ଟ୍ରାନ୍ଜାକ୍ସନ୍ ନାହିଁ, ରାଇଟ୍? ସୋ ଦେୟାର ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ କଲ୍ଡ ଏ ୱାର୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ମାଉଥ୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିକେସନ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ନଟ୍ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ। ସୋ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ? ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ ଇଜ୍ ଏନି ପେଡ୍ ଫର୍ମ ଅଫ୍ ନନ୍ ପର୍ସନାଲ ପ୍ରେଜେଣ୍ଟେସନ୍ ଅର୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିକେସନ୍ ରିଲେଟେଡ୍ ଟୁ ଏ ସ୍ପେସିଫିକ୍ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ଟ, ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ, ଆଇଡିଆ, ବଟ୍ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ଆନ୍ ଆଇଡେଣ୍ଟିଫାଏଡ୍ ସ୍ପନ୍ସର। ସୋ ଏଇ ତିନିଟା କି ୱାର୍ଡ ଯଦି ଆବସେଣ୍ଟ ଅଛି ବା ଏଇ ତିନିଟା କ୍ରାଇଟେରିଆକୁ ସେ ସିଚୁଏସନ୍ ଫୁଲଫିଲ୍ କରୁନାହିଁ, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ। ରିମେମ୍ବର ଦିସ୍। ଦେନ୍ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଆର୍ ଦ ଅବଜେକ୍ଟିଭ୍ସ ଅଫ୍ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ? ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ଫୋର୍ ବ୍ରଡ୍ ଅବଜେକ୍ଟିଭ୍ସ। ୱାନ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଟୁ ଇନଫର୍ମ, ୱାନ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଟୁ ପରସୁଏଡ୍, ଆନାଦର ଟୁ ଆର୍ ରିମାଇଣ୍ଡ ଆଣ୍ଡ ରିଏନ୍ଫୋର୍ସ। ଇନଫର୍ମ ମାନେ କ'ଣ? ଆମକୁ ଜଣେଇବ। କ'ଣ ଜଣେଇବ? ପ୍ରଡ଼କ୍ଟ ବିଷୟରେ, ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ ବିଷୟରେ, ତାର ବେନିଫିଟ୍ ବିଷୟରେ, ତାର ଫଙ୍କସନ୍ ବିଷୟରେ, ଆମେ କାହିଁକି ତାକୁ କିଣିବା, ଏସବୁ ବିଷୟରେ। ଆପଣ ମନେ ପକାନ୍ତୁ, ଯେତେବେଳେ ଅମିତାଭ ବଚ୍ଚନ ଆସିକି କହୁଛନ୍ତି ଯେ ନିଜର ଛୋଟ ଛୁଆକୁ ନେଇକି ଯାଆନ୍ତୁ, ପୋଲିଓର ଦୁଇଟା ବୁନ୍ଦା ତାଙ୍କୁ ଖୁଆନ୍ତୁ, ଦୋ ବୁନ୍ଦ ପୋଲିଓ କି ଆଉ କ'ଣ ଭୁଲିଗଲି, ଯାହା ବି, ରାଇଟ୍? ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଇନଫର୍ମେସନ୍ ବିଙ୍ଗ୍ ସେୟାର୍ଡ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଲଜିକ୍ ବିଙ୍ଗ୍ ଗିଭେନ୍, ଯେ କାହିଁକି ଆପଣ ସେଇ ପୋଲିଓର ଦୁଇ ବୁନ୍ଦା ଆପଣଙ୍କ ଛୁଆକୁ ଖୁଆଇବେ, ଆଉ କେଉଁ ଛୁଆକୁ, ତାକୁ କେତେ ବର୍ଷ ବୟସ ହେଇଥିବ ଏବଂ କେଉଁଠି ଖୁଆଇବେ, ରାଇଟ୍? ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ଇନଫର୍ମେସନ୍। ଆମେ ଯଦି କୌଣସି ମୋବାଇଲ ହ୍ୟାଣ୍ଡସେଟ୍ କଥା କହିବା, ସେଥିରେ ଆମକୁ କେଉଁ କେଉଁ ଇନଫର୍ମେସନ୍ ମିଳୁଛି, ଏଥିରେ କେତେ ମେଗାପିକ୍ସେଲ କ୍ୟାମେରା ଅଛି, କେତେ ବ୍ୟାଟେରୀ ବ୍ୟାକ୍ଅପ୍ ଅଛି, କେତେ କ'ଣ ପ୍ରୋସେସିଂ ସ୍ପିଡ୍ କେତେ ଅଛି, କେଉଁ ଅପରେଟିଂ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ଅଛି, କେତେ ମେମୋରି କାପାସିଟି ଅଛି, ଆଣ୍ଡ ସୋ ଅନ୍। ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଗୋଟେ ବାଇକ୍ ବା କାର୍ ବିଷୟରେ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟ ଦେଖୁଛୁ ବା କେଉଁ ଟାଇପ୍ର ଇନଫର୍ମେସନ୍ ପାଉଛୁ, ଯେ ଏଥିରେ ମାଇଲେଜ୍ କେତେ, କମ୍ଫର୍ଟ କ'ଣ, କେଉଁ ଟାଇପ୍ର ଇଞ୍ଜିନ୍ ବା କେଉଁ ଟାଇପ୍ର ଟେକ୍ନୋଲୋଜି ବା କେଉଁ ଟାଇପ୍ର ଏମିସନ୍ ଅଛି, ଆଣ୍ଡ ସୋ ଅନ୍। ସୋ ଇଚ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଏଭ୍ରି ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟ ପ୍ରୋଭାଇଡ୍ସ ସମ୍ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ଇନଫର୍ମେସନ୍ ଟୁ ଦ ଅଡିଏନ୍ସ, ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଫର୍ ସିଓର। ଆମେ ଯଦି ଦେଖିଥିବା କମ୍ପାନୀ ଲାଇକ୍ ଗୁଗୁଲ, ଏବେ ଯେମିତି ସେମାନେ ଗୁଗୁଲ ମ୍ୟାପ୍ର ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜ୍ କରୁଛନ୍ତି, ସେଠି ଆପଣ ଦେଖିବେ, ବା ଗୁଗୁଲ ସର୍ଚ୍ଚର ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟ କରୁଛନ୍ତି, ସେଠି ସେମାନେ କହୁଛନ୍ତି ଆପଣ କେମିତି ଭଏସ୍ ସର୍ଚ୍ଚ କରିପାରିବେ, ଯେମିତି ଆଲେକ୍ସା, ଆମାଜନ୍ କରୁଛି ଆଲେକ୍ସାର ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟ, ରାଇଟ୍? ସେଇଗୁଡ଼ା ତ ବେସିକ୍ ଫଙ୍କସନାଲିଟି, ବେସିକ୍ ଫିଚର୍ସ, ବେସିକ୍ ଏଲିମେଣ୍ଟସ୍ ରିଲେଟେଡ୍ ଟୁ ଦ ଅଫରିଂସ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ଟ, ବେନିଫିଟ ରିଲେଟେଡ୍ ଟୁ ଦ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ଟ ଆର୍ କମ୍ୟୁନିକେଟେଡ୍ ଥ୍ରୁ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ। ସେଟା ହେଲା ମାନେ ଗୋଟେ ମିନିମମ୍ ରିକ୍ୱାୟାରମେଣ୍ଟ କହିପାରିବା ବା ଗୋଟେ ଷ୍ଟାଣ୍ଡାର୍ଡ କହିପାରିବା, ଯେଉଁଟାକି ନିଶ୍ଚିତ ଥିବା ଦରକାର। ୱିଦାଉଟ୍ ସେୟାରିଂ ଏନି କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ଇନଫର୍ମେସନ୍, ହାଉ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ବି ଏ କମ୍ୟୁନିକେସନ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦ ଫର୍ଷ୍ଟ ଇନ୍ଷ୍ଟାନ୍ସ, ରାଇଟ୍? ଦେନ୍ ପରସୁଏଡ୍। ପରସୁଏଡ୍ ମାନେ କ'ଣ? ଆପଣଙ୍କ ମତକୁ ବା ଯିଏ ଭିୱର ଅଛନ୍ତି ତାଙ୍କ ମତକୁ ପ୍ରଭାବିତ କରିବ, ମତକୁ ପ୍ରଭାବିତ କରିବ ମାନେ କ'ଣ, ଇଟ୍ ୱିଲ୍ କ୍ରିଏଟ୍ ଏ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ଅର୍ଜେନ୍ସି ଅର୍ ଇଟ୍ ୱିଲ୍ କ୍ରିଏଟ୍ ଏ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ କ୍ୟୁରିଓସିଟି, ଇଟ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ଏକ୍ସାଇଟ୍ ଦ କଷ୍ଟମର ଟୁ ଆସ୍କ ଫର୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ପ୍ରଡକ୍ଟ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ ଆପଣ ହୁଏତ ଖୋଜିବେ ତାକୁ ଆପଣ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ଆର୍ ଏ ପୋଟେନ୍ସିଆଲ ବାୟର ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ୱିଲ୍ ସିକ୍ ଆଡିସନାଲ ଇନ୍ଫର୍ମେସନ ଆବାଉଟ୍ ଦ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ଟ ଆବାଉଟ୍ ଦ କମ୍ପାନୀ ଆବାଉଟ୍ ଦ ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ ମେ ବି ଯଦି ଆପଣମାନେ ବହୁତ ଜଣ ଯଦି ୟୁଥ୍ ବା ୟଙ୍ଗ ଅଛନ୍ତି ଆପଣ ଯଦି ମନେ ପକାଇ ପାରୁଥିବେ ଯେତେବେଳେ କ୍ୟାଡବରି ଡେରି ମିଲ୍କର ଭାଲେଣ୍ଟାଇନ୍ସ ଡେ ପାଖାପାଖି ଗୋଟେ ହାର୍ଟ ସେପ୍ ଥିବା ବାଲା ଗୋଟେ ଚକୋଲେଟ୍ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଲଞ୍ଚ ହେଲା ମେନି କଷ୍ଟମର୍ସ ଆଇ ହାଭ୍ ସିନ୍ ଇନ୍ ମଲ୍ସ ଆଇ ହାଭ୍ ସିନ୍ ଇନ୍ ୟୁ ନୋ ଅଦର ରିଟେଲ ଆଉଟଲେଟ୍ସ ୱେର୍ ପିପୁଲ୍ ଆର୍ ଆସ୍କିଂ ଫର୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ସେ ହାର୍ଟ ବାଲା ଚକୋଲେଟ୍ ଅଛି କି କ୍ୟାଡବରିର ରାଇଟ୍ ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ପରସୁଏସନ୍ ୟୁ ନୋ ସେଇଟା ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ କ୍ରିଏଟ୍ସ ଏ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ସେନ୍ସେସନ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ କ୍ରିଏଟ୍ସ ଏ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ରିକ୍ୱାୟାରମେଣ୍ଟ ଅର୍ ଫିଲିଂ ଅଫ୍ ଅର୍ଜେନ୍ସି ଲୋକ ଯାଇକି ପଚାରିବେ ଆଜ୍ଞା ସେଇଟା ଅଛି କି ତ ଯଦି ଦୋକାନୀ ବି ଜାଣିନଥିବ ବା ଦ ରିଟେଲର ଇଜ୍ ନଟ୍ ଅଲସୋ ଇନଫର୍ମଡ୍ ବା ସିଏ ସିଓର ନଥିବ ଯେ ମୁଁ ଏଇଟା ଗୋଟେ ନୂଆ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ଟ ଲଞ୍ଚ ହେଇଛି ତାକୁ ରଖିବି ନା ରଖିବିନି ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ନ୍ୟୁ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ଟ ଲଞ୍ଚ କଥା ପଢ଼ିଥିଲେ ଆଗରୁ ସେତେବେଳେ ଆମେ ଡିସ୍କସ୍ କରିଥିଲେ ଯେ ମୋଷ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ନ୍ୟୁ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ଟ ଲଞ୍ଚ ମୋଷ୍ଟଲି ଫେଲ୍ ତ ଯଦି ରିଟେଲର ସେଭଳିଆ ଡାଉଟ୍ରେ ଅଛି ଯେ ମୁଁ ଏଇଟା ରଖିବି ନା ରଖିବିନି ଆଣ୍ଡ ଗୋଟେ ଦିନରେ 5 ଜଣ ବା 10 ଜଣ ଆସିକି ପଚାରୁଛନ୍ତି ସୋ ହି ଅର୍ ସି ମାଇଟ୍ ଆକ୍ଚୁଆଲି କନସିଡର କିଏ କ'ଣ ବହୁତ ଲୋକ ପଚାରୁଛନ୍ତି ତା ମାନେ ଲୋକଙ୍କର ଡିମାଣ୍ଡ ଅଛି ଲୋକ ଚାହୁଁଛନ୍ତି କିଣିବା ପାଇଁ ତ ସିଏ କମ୍ପାନୀକୁ କଣ୍ଟାକ୍ଟ କରିବ ରାଇଟ୍ ବା ଡିଷ୍ଟ୍ରିବ୍ୟୁଟରକୁ କଣ୍ଟାକ୍ଟ କରିବ ଯେ ଏଇ ଜିନିଷଟା ଆଣୁନ ଏଇଟା କ'ଣ ବହୁତ ଲୋକ ଆସିକି ପଚାରୁଛନ୍ତି ଯଦି ଡିଷ୍ଟ୍ରିବ୍ୟୁଟର ପାଖରେ ଥିବ ଦେନ୍ ଦ ଡିଷ୍ଟ୍ରିବ୍ୟୁଟର ୱିଲ୍ ଇମିଡିଏଟଲି ସପ୍ଲାଏ ଦ ଗୁଡ୍ସ ଅର୍ ଦ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ଟ ଟୁ ଦ ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ ସରି ଦ ରିଟେଲର ଯଦି ତାଙ୍କ ପାଖରେ ବି ନଥିବ ସିଏ ବି ଡାଉଟଫୁଲ୍ ଥିବେ ସିଏ ପୁଣି କମ୍ପାନୀ ତାଙ୍କର ଯିଏ ସପ୍ଲାଇ ଚେନ୍ର ତାର ଅଦର ଇଣ୍ଟରମିଡିଆରି ଥିବେ ବା ସେ ଡାଇରେକ୍ଟଲି କମ୍ପାନୀକୁ କଣ୍ଟାକ୍ଟ କରିବେ ଯେ ସେଇ କ'ଣ ଏଇଟା ଗୋଟେ ନୂଆ ହେଇଛି ଏଇଟା ଦିଅ ଆମର ଡିମାଣ୍ଡ ଅଛି ରାଇଟ୍ ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ କ୍ରିଏଟ୍ସ ବୋଥ୍ ପୁଲ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ପୁଶ୍ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଟେଜି କ୍ରିଏଟ୍ ଏ ଡିମାଣ୍ଡ ପୁଲ୍ ଅର୍ ଡିମାଣ୍ଡ ପୁଶ୍ ରାଇଟ୍ ସେଇଟା ଆମେ ସବୁ ପଢ଼ିବା ବା ଆମେ ଆଗରୁ ପଢ଼ିଛନ୍ତି ପୁଶ୍ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଟେଜି କ'ଣ ପୁଲ୍ ଷ୍ଟ୍ରାଟେଜି କ'ଣ ରାଇଟ୍ ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ପରସୁଏଡ୍ସ ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ୍ସ ଲୋକ ଯାଇକି ପଚାରିବେ ଏଇଟା ଅଛି କି ଆଣ ଆମେ ବ୍ୟବହାର କରିବୁ ବା ଲୋକ ଯାଇକି ଦେଖିବାକୁ ଚାହିଁବେ ବହୁତ ଲୋକ ହୁଏତ ସେମାନେ କିଣିପାରନ୍ତି ବା ନ କିଣିପାରନ୍ତି ବଟ୍ ଲୋକମାନେ ଦେଖିବେ ଯାଇକି ଦେ ୱିଲ୍ ଇଫ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ଲ୍ୟାପଟପ୍ ଅର୍ ଏ ସ୍ମାର୍ଟଫୋନ୍ ଲୋକ ଯାଇକି ଦେଖିବେ ଏଇଟା କ'ଣ କେମିତି ହେଉଛି ଆଣ୍ଡ ପିପୁଲ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ଟ୍ରାଏ ଟୁ ହାଭ୍ ଦେୟାର ଓନ୍ ଫେୟାର୍ ସେୟାର ଅଫ୍ ଏକ୍ସପିରିଏନ୍ସ ରିଲେଟେଡ୍ ଟୁ ଦ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ଟ ଅର୍ ରିଲେଟେଡ୍ ଟୁ ଦ ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ ଦେନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ରିମାଇଣ୍ଡସ୍ ଦେମ୍ ରିମାଇଣ୍ଡ ମାନେ ମନେ ପକାଇଦେବ ମନେ ପକାଇଦେବ ଯେ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ଟ କ'ଣ ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ କ'ଣ ଭାଲ୍ୟୁ ପ୍ରପୋଜିସନ୍ କ'ଣ କାହିଁକି କିଣିବେ ଅଫର୍ କେତେ ଦିନ ଯାଏ ଭ୍ୟାଲିଡ୍ ଅଲ୍ ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ରିମାଇଣ୍ଡର୍ସ ଗିଭେନ୍ ବାଏ ଦ କମ୍ପାନୀ ଅର୍ ବାଏ ଦ ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ ଅର୍ ବାଏ ଦ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜର୍ସ ଅନ୍ ରେଗୁଲାର ଇଣ୍ଟରଭାଲ୍ ମନେ ପକାଇଦେବ ସେ ଭୁଲିବାକୁ ଦେବନି ଆଣ୍ଡ ଅଲ୍ଟିମେଟଲି ଇଟ୍ ଦ ମେସେଜ୍ ଇଜ୍ ରିଏନ୍ଫୋର୍ସଡ୍ ରିଏନ୍ଫୋର୍ସଡ୍ ମାନେ ସେଟା ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଲିଭ୍ସ ଏ ପର୍ମାନେଣ୍ଟ ଇମ୍ପ୍ରେସନ୍ ଅନ୍ ଦ ଅଡିଏନ୍ସ ମନରେ ସେଟା ପେଷ୍ଟ ହେଇଯିବ ବା ଗୋଟେ ପ୍ରତିଛବି ଅଲରେଡି କ୍ରିଏଟ୍ ହେଇଯିବ ଆପଣ ଡାହାଣ ପଟେ ଦେଖନ୍ତୁ ଯେତେ ଗୁଡ଼େ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟ ଅଛି ହୁଏତ ବହୁତ ଛୋଟ ଆକାରରେ ଦେଖାଯାଉଥିବ ମୁଁ ଭାବୁଛି ତା ଭିତରୁ ବହୁତ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟକୁ ଆପଣ ମନେ ପକାଇ ପାରୁଥିବେ ସେ ଅମିତାଭ ବଚ୍ଚନଙ୍କର ଆଓ କଭି ଗୁଜରାତ ମେ କୁଛ ଦିନ ବିତାଓ ସେ କ୍ୟାମ୍ପେନ୍ ହଉ ବା ଏଇ ଯୋଉ ଭୋଡ଼ାଫୋନ୍ର ସେଇ ଡଗ୍ ବାଲା କ୍ୟାମ୍ପେନ୍ ହଉ ବା ଭୋଡ଼ାଫୋନ୍ ଜୁଜୁ ବାଲା କ୍ୟାମ୍ପେନ୍ ହଉ ବା ଥଣ୍ଡା ମତଲବ କୋକା କୋଲା କ୍ୟାମ୍ପେନ୍ ହଉ ରାଇଟ୍ ସୋ ଅଲ୍ ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ରିଇନ୍ଫୋର୍ସଡ୍ ଇନ୍ ଆର୍ ମାଇଣ୍ଡ ଏଇ ସବୁର ଇମ୍ପ୍ରେସନ୍ ଆମ ମନରେ ବସି ଯାଇଛି ବା ଆମ ମାଇଣ୍ଡରେ ଅଲରେଡି ଇମ୍ପ୍ରିଣ୍ଟ ବା ପେଷ୍ଟ ହେଇଯାଇଛି ମନେ ରହିଯାଇଛି ଏଇଗୁଡ଼ା ରାଇଟ୍ ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ଇମ୍ପ୍ରେ ଭାବନ୍ତୁ ଏ ପ୍ରକାରର ଇମ୍ପ୍ରେସନ କେତେ କେତେ ପାୱାରଫୁଲ ମେସେଜ ହେଲେ ହିଁ ଏଇ ଭଳିଆ ମେସେଜଟା ମନେ ରହିବ। ଆପଣ ଭାବନ୍ତୁ ମୁଁ ଏବେ କେତେ ଆମେ ୱି ହାଭ୍ ବିନ୍ ଡିସ୍କସିଂ ସୋ ମେନି ଥିଙ୍ଗସ ବଟ୍ ଇଟ୍ ମାଇଟ୍ ବି ପସିବଲ ଫର୍ ମେନି ଅଫ୍ ୟୁ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ୟୁ ଓନ୍ଲି ରିମେମ୍ବର ସମ୍ ପାର୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଦ କମ୍ୟୁନିକେସନ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ୱି ହାଭ୍ ଏନଗେଜ୍ ଇନ୍ ରାଇଟ। ତ ଭାବନ୍ତୁ ଯେମିତି ଜୟ ଯବାନ ଜୟ କିଷାନ ଏ ସ୍ଲୋଗାନ ଆମ ମନରେ ଅଛି ବା ତମେ ମୋତେ ରକ୍ତ ଦିଅ ମୁଁ ତମକୁ ସ୍ୱାଧୀନତା ଦେବି ଏ ସ୍ଲୋଗାନ ବା ଅଙ୍ଗ୍ରେଜ ଭାରତ ଛୋଡ଼ ଏସବୁ ଯୋଉ ସ୍ଲୋଗାନ ଅଛି ଯୋଉ କାଳଜୟୀ ସ୍ଲୋଗାନ ଆମେ ଆମ ମନରେ ବା ଏଇଟା ଗୋଟେ ଆମେ ହୁଏତ ସେତେବେଳେ ଜନ୍ମ ବି ହେଇନଥିଲେ କିନ୍ତୁ ଆମେ ଯୋଉ ପଢିଛନ୍ତି ଶୁଣିଛନ୍ତି ଜାଣିଛନ୍ତି ସେ ସେଇ ସେଇ ଟାଇପ୍ର କମ୍ୟୁନିକେସନରୁ ଆମ ମନରେ ଏ ଟାଇପ୍ର ଗୋଟେ ଛବି ରହିଯାଇଛି ଏଇ ସ୍ଲୋଗାନ ଗୁଡ଼ା ମନେ ରହିଯାଇଛି। ସେଇଭଳିଆ ଗୋଟେ ଆମେ ଯଦି କମ୍ପାନୀ ବା ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡର ମେସେଜ କଥା କହିବା ସେଟା ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ହାଜ୍ ଟୁ ବି ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ମଚ୍ ପାୱାରଫୁଲ ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ପିପୁଲ ୱିଲ୍ ରିମେମ୍ବର। ବା ଆମେ ଯଦି ମନେ ପକେଇବା କ୍ଲୋରମିଣ୍ଟର ଯୋଉ ଆଡ୍ ଥିଲା ଦୁବାରା ମତ ପୁଛନା ଯେତେବେଳେ ସେ ଆମ କ୍ଲୋରମିଣ୍ଟ କ୍ୟୁ ଖାତେ ହେଁ କହିଲେ ସେ ତାକୁ ପାଣିରେ ବୁଡ଼ଉଥିଲା କି ମାରୁଥିଲା କି କ'ଣ କରୁଥିଲା ରାଇଟ। ସୋ ଅଲ୍ ଦୋଜ୍ କ୍ୟାମ୍ପେନ୍ସ ୱି ଷ୍ଟିଲ୍ ରିମେମ୍ବର ଆଣ୍ଡ ଆମେ ଏବେ ବି ସେ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟ ଗୁଡ଼ା ଦେଖିଲେ ବହୁତ ସମୟରେ ଆମେ ୱି ଫିଲ୍ ନଷ୍ଟାଲଜିକ୍ ଆମ ପିଲାଦିନ କଥା ମନେ ପଡ଼ିଯାଏ ରାଇଟ। ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ପାୱାର ଅଫ୍ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ପାୱାର ଅଫ୍ ମାର୍କେଟିଂ କମ୍ୟୁନିକେସନ ଇଟ୍ ଲିଭ୍ସ ଏ ସଲିଡ୍ ଇମ୍ପ୍ରେସନ୍ ଅନ୍ ଦ କଷ୍ଟମର୍ସ ଅର୍ ଦ ପୋଟେନ୍ସିଆଲ କଷ୍ଟମର୍ସ ଦେନ୍ ଇଟ୍ ରିଚେସ୍ ଲାର୍ଜ ଜିଓଗ୍ରାଫିକାଲି ଡିସ୍ପର୍ସଡ୍ ଅଡିଏନ୍ସ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଅଫନ୍ ୱିଥ୍ ହାଇ ଫ୍ରିକ୍ୱେନ୍ସି। ଏଇଟା ଆମେ ଗୋଟେ ଟେଲିଭିଜନ ଆଡ୍ ଯଦି ଆମେ ଗୋଟେ ପପୁଲାର ଚ୍ୟାନେଲରେ ଦେଖାଉଛନ୍ତି ସୋ ଏଇଟା ସେ ଚ୍ୟାନେଲ ଯୋଉଠି ଯୋଉଠି ଦେଖେଇବ ଏଇଟା ସେଇଠି ସେଇଠି ଦେଖେଇବ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟ। ଯଦି ଗୋଟେ ୱେବସାଇଟରେ ଆମେ ଆଡ୍ ଦେଉଛନ୍ତି ସୋ ମୋଷ୍ଟ ଲାଇକଲି ଇଟ୍ କ୍ରସେସ୍ ଇଭେନ୍ ଫର୍ଦର ବାଉଣ୍ଡ୍ରିଜ୍ ଇଟ୍ ରିଚେସ୍ ମୋର ନମ୍ବର ଅଫ୍ କଷ୍ଟମର୍ସ ଅର୍ ପୋଟେନ୍ସିଆଲ କଷ୍ଟମର୍ସ ଅର୍ ଅଡିଏନ୍ସ ଇନ୍ ଜେନେରାଲ। ଦେନ୍ ଆମେ ଯଦି ଏକ୍ସପୋଜର ପଏଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଭ୍ୟୁରୁ ମାନେ କେତେ ଜଣ ଲୋକଙ୍କ ପାଖରେ ପହଞ୍ଚିଲା ସେ ଦୃଷ୍ଟିରୁ ଦେଖିବା ଦ କଷ୍ଟ ଇଜ୍ ଭେରି ଲୋ। ବଟ୍ ଇଫ୍ ୱି କନ୍ସିଡର ଦ ଟୋଟାଲ ଆମାଉଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଇନ୍ଭେଷ୍ଟମେଣ୍ଟ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଗୋଜ୍ ଇନ୍ ଟୁ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଭେରି ହାଏ। ଲେଟ୍ ମି ଏଲାବୋରେଟ୍ ଦିସ୍। ଲେଟ୍ ସେ ଆମେ ଏବେ ଗୋଟେ ଟେଲିଭିଜନରେ ଆଡ୍ ଦେବା ଟିଭି ଆଡ୍ କଥା କହୁଛି ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ପେପର କଥା ତାପରେ କହିବି। ଟିଭିରେ ଯଦି ଗୋଟେ ଆମେ ଆଡ୍ ଦେଉଛନ୍ତି ଆମର କ'ଣ କ'ଣ ଦରକାର ସେଇଟା ତିଆରି କରିବା ପାଇଁ ଫାର୍ଷ୍ଟ ୱି ନିଡ୍ ଟୁ ହାଭ୍ ଏ ମେସେଜ୍। ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ପ୍ରଫେସନାଲ୍ସ ହୁ କ୍ୟାନ୍ ରାଇଟ୍ ଦ ମେସେଜ୍ ଅର୍ ଆମେ ତାକୁ ମେ ବି ବିଭିନ୍ନ ରାଇଟର ଅଛନ୍ତି ଯେଉଁମାନେ କି ଯେମିତି ପ୍ରସୂନ ଯୋଶୀ ହେଲେ ଲିରିସିଷ୍ଟ ଅଛନ୍ତି ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ସେଲିବ୍ରିଟିଜ୍ ଆଜ୍ ୱେଲ୍ ଇନ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଡୋମେନ୍। ଦେନ୍ ଦେର୍ ଆର୍ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ ଏଜେନ୍ସିଜ୍ ଯେଉଁମାନେ କି ସେଇ କନସେପ୍ଟ ବା ସେଇ ସ୍ଲୋଗାନ ବା ସେଇ ଜିଙ୍ଗଲକୁ ନେଇକି ଫର୍ଦର କନସେପ୍ଟ ଡେଭଲପ୍ କରିବେ। ଦେନ୍ ୱି ମାଇଟ୍ ନିଡ୍ ସମ୍ ଆକ୍ଟର୍ସ ଆକ୍ଟର ଡାଇରେକ୍ଟର ଗୋଟେ ସୁଟିଂ ସେଟଅପ୍ ମେ ବି ଏ ଲଟ୍ ଅଫ୍ ହ୍ୟୁମାନ ବିଙ୍ଗ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଟେକ୍ନୋଲୋଜି ଆଣ୍ଡ ମନି ଆଣ୍ଡ ଟାଇମ୍। ଗୋଟେ ଯଦି ଆମେ ଦେଖିବା ଡ୍ୟୁରେସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ଆଡ୍ ଟେଲିଭିଜନ ଆଡ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଆବାଉଟ 10 seconds। ବଟ୍ ଆପଣ ଭାବନ୍ତୁ ସେଇ 10 seconds ଆଡ୍ରେ ଯଦି ସଲମାନ ଖାନ ଅଛନ୍ତି କି ଶାହରୁଖ ଖାନ ଅଛନ୍ତି ବା ଅଲଗା କେଉଁ ସେଲିବ୍ରିଟି ଅଛନ୍ତି ତାଙ୍କର କେତେ ସେମାନେ ପାରିଶ୍ରମିକ ନେଉଥିବେ ସେଇ 10 seconds ଗୋଟେ ଆଡ୍ ପାଇଁ। ତା ପଛରେ ଯେଉଁମାନେ ବହୁତ ଏଇ କନସେପ୍ଟ ଡେଭଲପମେଣ୍ଟ ଯିଏ କଲେ ଯେଉଁମାନେ ସୁଟିଂରେ ସହାୟତା କଲେ ସେ କ୍ୟାମେରାମ୍ୟାନ୍ ସେ ଡାଇରେକ୍ଟର ମେକଅପ୍ ଆର୍ଟିଷ୍ଟ ଯେଉଁମାନେ ସବୁ ସ୍ପଟ୍ ବୟ ଯେତେ ଜଣ ଅଛନ୍ତି ସେମାନେ କେତେ ପଇସା ନେବେ ଦେନ୍ ଦିସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ୱାନ୍ ପାର୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଇଟ୍। ତାପରେ ସେଟା ଏଡିଟିଂ ହବ ସେଥିରେ ଗ୍ରାଫିକ୍ସ ଆଡ୍ ହବ ବହୁତ ଜିନିଷ ଅଛି। ଅଲ୍ଟିମେଟଲି ଲେଟ୍ ସେ 10 seconds ଆଡ୍ ହେଇଗଲା କିନ୍ତୁ ଖର୍ଚ୍ଚ ଏତିକିରେ ସରିନି ଖର୍ଚ୍ଚ ଆହୁରି ଅଛି କ'ଣ ଦେନ୍ ଦ ଏକ୍ସପେନ୍ସିଭ ପାର୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ବ୍ରଡ଼କାଷ୍ଟିଂ ପାର୍ଟ। କେଉଁଠି ଏଇ ଟିଭି କେଉଁ ଟିଭି ଚ୍ୟାନେଲରେ ଦେଖେଇବ କେତେବେଳେ ଦେଖେଇବ କେଉଁ ଶୋରେ ଦେଖେଇବ ମନେକର ଆମେ କହିଲେ ସୋନିରେ ଦେଖେଇବ କପିଲ ଶର୍ମା ଶୋରେ ଦେନ୍ ସେଇ 10 seconds ର ପ୍ରାଇସ୍ କିଛି ଲକ୍ଷ ଟଙ୍କା ବା କୋଟି ଟଙ୍କାରେ ହବ। ଆଉ କେତେ ଥର ଦେଖିବ, କ'ଣ ଥରେ ଦେଖିକି ବନ୍ଦ କରିଦବ? ସେ ଶୋରେ ମନେକର 4ଟା କି 5ଟା କି 6ଟା ବ୍ରେକ୍ ଅଛି, ସେ ବ୍ରେକ୍ରେ 6 ଥର ଯଦି ଦେଖିବ ଇନ୍ଟୁ ସେତିକି ଲକ୍ଷ ଟଙ୍କା ବା ସେତିକି କୋଟି ଟଙ୍କା, ରାଇଟ୍? ସେମିତି କେବଳ କ'ଣ ସେଇ ଚ୍ୟାନେଲରେ ସେ ଗୋଟିଏ ଶୋରେ ଦେଖିବ, ସେଇ ଚ୍ୟାନେଲରେ ଅଲଗା ଶୋ ବି ଥିବ ସେଠି ବି ଦେଖେଇବ ହୁଏତ, ସେମିତି ଅଲଗା ଚ୍ୟାନେଲ ଅଛନ୍ତି, ବହୁତ ଗୁଡ଼ିଏ ଚ୍ୟାନେଲ ଅଛନ୍ତି, ହୁଏତ ସେଠି ବି ଦେଖେଇବ, ହୁଏତ ୟୁଟ୍ୟୁବରେ ବି ଦେଖେଇବ, ରାଇଟ୍? ସୋ ଏବେ ଭାବନ୍ତୁ ଏସବୁକୁ ମଲ୍ଟିପ୍ଲାଏ କରନ୍ତୁ, ସେ ସୁଟିଂ ସେଲିବ୍ରିଟି ତାଙ୍କର କଷ୍ଟ ବା ସେ ଏକ୍ସପେଣ୍ଡିଚର ଗୋଟେ ପାର୍ଟ ଗଲା, ଏବେ ଭାବନ୍ତୁ ଏଇ 10 ସେକେଣ୍ଡ ଯେତେ ଆମେ ସ୍ଲଟ୍ ହାୟର କରିବା ପ୍ରତ୍ୟେକ ଚ୍ୟାନେଲରେ, ଯେକୌଣସି ଚ୍ୟାନେଲ ହଉ ଯେକୌଣସି ପ୍ରୋଗ୍ରାମ ହଉ, ସେଟା ବି ଦ ଏକ୍ସପେଣ୍ଡିଚର ଅର୍ ଦ ଟୋଟାଲ ବଜେଟ ୱିଲ୍ ଫର୍ଦର ଇନକ୍ରିଜ। କିନ୍ତୁ ହଁ, ଆମେ ଯଦି କହିବା ଏକ୍ସପୋଜର କେତେ ଲୋକଙ୍କ ପାଖରେ ପହଞ୍ଚୁଛି, ଆମେ ଯଦି ଟୋଟାଲ ଏକ୍ସପେଣ୍ଡିଚରକୁ ଡିଭାଇଡ କରିବା ବାଇ ଦ ନମ୍ବର ଅଫ୍ ଅଡିଏନ୍ସ ଅର୍ ବାଇ ଦ ନମ୍ବର ଅଫ୍ ରିଚ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ଆଡଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟ, କେତେ ଲୋକଙ୍କ ପାଖରେ ଏଇ ଆଡଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟ ପହଞ୍ଚିଲା, ସେ ହିସାବଟା ବା ସେ ରେସିଓଟା ହୁଏତ କମ୍ ହେଇପାରେ। କିନ୍ତୁ ଯଦି ଓଭରଅଲ୍ ଏକ୍ସପେଣ୍ଡିଚର ଟୋଟାଲ ବଜେଟ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ କ୍ୟାମ୍ପେନ୍ ଆମେ ଦେଖିବା, ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଭେରି ଭେରି ହ୍ୟୁଜ୍। ଯଦି ଗୋଟେ IPL ଭଳିଆ ପ୍ରୋଗ୍ରାମରେ, ସରି, ଗୋଟେ ଇଭେଣ୍ଟରେ ଆମେ ଟାଇଟଲ ସ୍ପନ୍ସର ହେଉଛନ୍ତି ପେପ୍ସି ବା DLF ଆଗରୁ ଥିଲା ବା ଭିଭୋ ବା ଆମେ ମାଇକ୍ରୋମାକ୍ସ, କୌଣସି ଗୋଟେ ଏନି ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ ଇଜ୍ ବିକମିଂ ଦ ଟାଇଟଲ ସ୍ପନ୍ସର, ଭାବନ୍ତୁ କେତେ କୋଟି ବା କେତେ 100 କୋଟି ବା କେତେ 1000 କୋଟି ସେମାନେ ସ୍ପେଣ୍ଡ କରୁଥିବେ। ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ଅଲ୍ ଦ ବଜେଟ୍ସ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଆର୍ ଟୁ ବି ଆଲୋକେଟେଡ୍, ଏମିତି ନୁହଁ ଯେ ସେମିତି ଚାହିଁଲେ ହେଇଯିବେ, ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ଅଲ୍ କଣ୍ଟ୍ରାକ୍ଟ ସେମାନେ ସାଇନ୍ କରିବେ ଯେ ସେମାନେ ଏତିକି କୋଟି ଟଙ୍କା ବା ଦିସ୍ ଆମାଉଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ମନି ଦେ ଆର୍ ଗୋଇଂ ଟୁ ସ୍ପେଣ୍ଡ ଆଜ୍ ଦ ଟାଇଟଲ ସ୍ପନ୍ସର। ଆଣ୍ଡ ଅଫକୋର୍ସ ସେଥିରେ ବି ଥିବ ଯେ ହ୍ୱାଟ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ବେନିଫିଟ୍ ଦେ ଆର୍ ଗୋଇଂ ଟୁ ଗେଟ୍ ଆଉଟ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ଡିଲ୍, ରାଇଟ୍? ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ୟୁ ନୋ ଏକ୍ସପୋଜର ଆଣ୍ଡ ଏକ୍ସପେଣ୍ଡିଚର ପାର୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ଆଡଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ ପ୍ରୋସେସ। ଦେନ୍ କଷ୍ଟମର୍ସ ଅର୍ କନ୍ଜ୍ୟୁମର୍ସ ପରସିଭ୍ ଆଡଭର୍ଟାଇଜ୍ ଲେଜିଟିମେଟ୍ସ। ଯେମିତି ବହୁତ ଜଣ ଆମେ ଭାବୁ ଯେ ଏଇଟା ଗୋଟେ ଟିଭିରେ ଦେଖେଇଲା ମାନେ, ଯେମିତି ବହୁତ ଜଣ ଭାବନ୍ତି ଏଇଟା ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ସଆପ୍ରେ ଅଛି ବା ଫେସବୁକ୍ରେ ଅଛି ମାନେ ଏଇଟା ସତ, ଏଇଟା ବା ନେଟ୍ରେ ଆସୁଛି ଏଇ ଇନଫର୍ମେସନ୍, ଏଇଟା ତାମାନେ ସତ। ତ ସେମିତି ବହୁତ ଜଣ ଭାବନ୍ତି ଯେ ଆଡଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟ ଯଦି ଦେଖେଇଲା ଟେଲିଭିଜନରେ ବା ଟିଭିରେ ଯଦି ଦେଖେଇଲା ତାମାନେ ଏଇଟା ସତ। ଯେମିତି ମୁଁ ନିଜ ମୋ ବ୍ୟକ୍ତିଗତ ଏକ୍ଜାମ୍ପଲ ମୁଁ ଏଇଟା ହୁଏତ ଆଗରୁ ଦେଇଥିଲି, ତଥାପି ମୁଁ ଆଉ ଥରେ କହିବାକୁ ଚାହୁଁଛି, ମୁଁ ଯେତେବେଳେ ପ୍ରଥମେ ଅଲ୍ ଆଉଟ୍ ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡର ଆଡଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟ ଦେଖିଲି, ଯେ ସେଇ ଯେଉଁ ଡିଭାଇସ୍ଟା ସେମାନେ ଅବଶ୍ୟ ଆନିମେସନ୍ ଥ୍ରୁରେ ଦେଖାଉଥିଲେ ଯେ ମଶାକୁ ଉଡ଼ି ଉଡ଼ି ଡେଇଁ ଡେଇଁ ଖାଇଦେଉଛି, ମୁଁ ଭାବିଲି ଯେ ଆକ୍ଚୁଆଲି ଯଦି ସେ ଡିଭାଇସ୍ଟା ଲାଗିବ ଘରେ ସେ ସବୁ ଉଡ଼ିକି ମଶା ଖାଇଦେବ। ତ ଆମ ଘରେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ପ୍ରଥମେ ଅଲ୍ ଆଉଟ୍ର ସେ ମସିନ୍ ବା ସେ ଡିଭାଇସ୍ଟା ଆସିକି ଲାଗିଲା, ମୁଁ ଛୋଟ ହେଇଥିଲି ଆଉ ମୁଁ ତାକୁ ଚାହିଁ ବସିଲି ସେ କେତେବେଳେ ଡେଇଁକି କେମିତି ଖାଇବ, ବଟ୍ ସିଏ ଖାଇଲାନି। ସୋ ମେ ବି ମୁଁ ସେତେବେଳେ ଛୋଟ ଥିଲି, ବୁଝିନଥିଲି, ବା ବହୁତ ଜଣ ବଡ଼ ଲୋକ ବି ସେମିତି ବୁଝିପାରନ୍ତିନି। ପିପୁଲ୍ ମାଇଟ୍ ପରସିଭ୍ ଆଡଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟସ୍ ଦ ୱେ ଦେ ଆର୍, ବୁଝି ହେଉଛି? So that is, and the dramatizing effects of brand as and companies. ଆମେ ଜାଣିଛୁ ଯେ ଆମେ ଥମ୍ସ ଅପ୍ କହିଲେ ଯେଉଁ ଟେଷ୍ଟ ଦ ଥଣ୍ଡର, ସେ ଆଡଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟରେ ଆମେ ସେଇ ଥଣ୍ଡର ବାଲା ଫିଲ୍ ପାଉ, ଯେ ଗୋଟେ ଥମ୍ସ ଅପ୍ ବୋତଲ ପାଇବା ପାଇଁ ଜଣେ ସେଲିବ୍ରିଟି କ'ଣ ବୋଲି କ'ଣ କରିଦେଉଛନ୍ତି, ସେ ହେଲିକପ୍ଟରରୁ କେଉଁଠି ଜମ୍ପ ମାରୁଛନ୍ତି, କେଉଁଠି ବିଲ୍ଡିଂରୁ ବିଲ୍ଡିଂ ଡେଇଁ ଡେଇଁ ଯାଉଛନ୍ତି, କେଉଁଠି ଆଉ କ'ଣ କରୁଛନ୍ତି, କେଉଁଠି ପାହାଡ଼ରୁ ଡେଇଁ ପଡ଼ୁଛନ୍ତି, ଆଣ୍ଡ ସୋ ଅନ୍। So ultimately that builds the brand image, that creates the kind of sales target or demand pull that is required to achieve the numbers. ebe to khali spend heigala tapare income bi hobo na, to se income pai revenue pai sales pai advertisements that also contributes. Then the biggest disadvantage of advertising is it is impersonal or non-personal and it is one way. ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଟିଭି ଦେଖୁଛୁ ବା ନ୍ୟୁଜ୍ ପେପର ପଢ଼ୁଛୁ, ସେଥିରେ ଯେଉଁ ଆଡଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟ ଦେଖୁଛୁ ବା ଆଡଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟ ସଂସ୍ପର୍ଶରେ ଆମେ ଆସୁଛୁ, ଦେୟାର ଇଜ୍ ଆବସଲ୍ୟୁଟଲି ନୋ ସ୍କୋପ୍ ଫର୍ ଅସ୍ ଟୁ ଗିଭ୍ ଏନି କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ଫିଡ଼ବ୍ୟାକ୍। ଆମେ ସେଠି କୌଣସି ଫିଡ଼ବ୍ୟାକ୍ ଦେଇପାରିବା ନାହିଁ, बट हैड इट बीन एनी इंटरेक्टिव मीडिया जदि इंटरनेट हितांदा बा सोशल मीडिया हितांदा सेठी आमे आमरो इंस्टेंट रिएक्शन वी कुड हैव इजीली शेयर्ड बट टीवी रे किछ करि पारियन हां जदि पागला क्रिकेट फैन हेतिबो निजो पसंदीदा टीम मैच हारी गला टीवी भांगी दे पारिबो बट से कम्युनिकेशन बा से इमोशन टा कंपनी पाखरे बा क्रिकेट टीम पाखरे हुए त पहुंचिला नाही unless until it is covered by some news channels or news agencies tame tama ghare tv baade ki bhangi dele bi that message is not going to reach to the customer to the company or players right so advertising is one way communication how would a disadvantage since we are talking the strengths and weaknesses inform persuade remind reinforce am koi dele brand equity am koi dele can reach large audience am koi dele expensive koi dele then another thing is cluttered bhavantu how many companies are there how many times and how many mediums are there and how many times the companies or the brands are engaging or trying to engage with us juade galle gote brand gote company konosi na konosi way re am sahita communicate kariya pai chahuchanti so the entire advertising space is highly cluttered jemte kohutili gote gote ghanti kiya tv show re hue to 4 ta ki 5 ta ki 6 ta gote break thibo से ब्रेक भितरे केतेटा कंपनी एड देखौचंती 5 मिनिट रे जदी ब्रेक अछि सेथरे से 10 सेकंड एड वाला बा 12 15 सेकंड एड वाला केतेटा सॉरी एडवर्टाइजमेंट बा केतेटा कंपनी हमकु देखौतबे आमे सब मने रखु नाहंती काहेकि ना सेठी आ जाउची सिलेक्टिव अटेंशन सिलेक्टिव रिटेंशन और सिलेक्टिव डिस्टॉर्शन जो आमे कहउतिले तार इंपैक्ट आउ जेहेतु वी आर कंटिन्यूअसली बम्बार्डेड विथ मार्केटिंग इन्फॉर्मेशन मार्केटिंग कम्युनिकेशन सो द एंटायर लैंडस्केप ऑफ एडवर्टाइजिंग इज हाइली क्लटर्ड पूरा माने आमे गोलमालिया बा गोलिया बा जंजालपूर्ण एंड लाइक वी हैव रिसेंटली डिस्कस्ड जस्ट नाउ इट इज वन वे कम्युनिकेशन दैट इज द ग्रेटेस्ट वीकनेस ऑफ एडवर्टाइजिंग देन टू योर लेफ्ट there are various types of advertising print broadcast ads packaging inserts motion pictures brochures booklets posters billboards pop display pop display mane point of purchase display jemti ame shopping mall re gola bale kini kina kini sarla pore eto bale ame bill kariya pai jau billing counter ba billing desk pakhuku ame dekhu सेठी आखा पाखरे बा डाहाण बा रे विभिन्न छोट छोट आइटम सब थुआ आइथिबो किंतु लोभनीय आइटम हेथिबो आमे सेठी छिडा हवा समय रे आम पाखरे किछ ऑप्शन न थाए आमे ताकु ही देखु थाउ बा बहुत समय रे आमे देखिछु जदी चॉकलेट बा किछ टॉयज बा खेलना फलना अछि बहुत छोट पिल्ला से माने आम सहित जदी अछंती बा आउ का सहित अछंती आमे देखिथिबा जे से माने जिद्दि करंती आमे से खेलना नबू बा चॉकलेट नबू बा जदी डिओड्रेंट अछि बा किछ परफ्यूम अछि जदी महिला माने अछंती दे ट्राई टू स्मेल और बहुत जण किणी भी दियंती आ जे जे गोटे अक्वार्ड परिस्थिति हुए गोटे छुआटे जदी मॉल रे कांदुची आ सेठी बहुत लोक अछंती आमे बेटर ताकु जदी चुप करि पार नांती बा बुझै पारु नांती तो बेटर ताकु किणे की धरै दियो से चुप होइ जइबो राइट so that is a pop display ba point of purchase display se moment re seta that compels us to ba seta lobhaniya hoitibo ba ame bhuli jaithiba seta kiniya pai kintu se choto se socks ho handkerchief ho ba au kichi se bula toy ho chocolate ho ame bhuwe to bhuli jaithu ba kichi fragrance ho ba deodorant ho ame jodi bhuli jaichu sethi amar mona padjibo ba seta lobhaniya se amku attract kariki किणवा पई से सिचुएशन रे बाध्य कर दो सो दोज आर पीओपी डिस्प्लेज देन लोगोस वीडियो टेप्स ऑल दीज आर वेरियस फॉर्म्स ऑफ एडवर्टाइजिंग देन सेल्स प्रमोशन दिस इज आल्सो वन ऑफ द वेरी पॉपुलर एंड वाइडली अडॉप्टेड प्रमोशनल टूल केबे भी भावंतु नहीं जे मार्केटिंग कम्युनिकेशन इज totally dependent only on advertising or it is synonymous to advertising there are so many other tools available advertising is only a part of the entire marketing communication arsenal. ସେଇଟା ଗୋଟିଏ ଅସ୍ତ୍ର, ଅଲଗା ଅସ୍ତ୍ର ବି ବହୁତ ଅଛି. ଆଣ୍ଡ ଆନଦର ପପୁଲାର ଟୁଲ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅର୍ ମେଥଡ୍ ଇଜ୍ ସେଲ୍ସ ପ୍ରମୋସନ୍. ସେଲ୍ସ ପ୍ରମୋସନ୍ର ଡେଫିନେସନ୍ କ'ଣ ହେଲା? ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ସର୍ଟ ଟର୍ମ ଇନ୍ସେଣ୍ଟିଭ୍ସ ଟୁ ଏନକରେଜ୍ ଦ ପର୍ଚେଜ୍ ଅର୍ ସେଲ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଏ ପର୍ଟିକୁଲାର ପ୍ରଡକ୍ଟ ଅର୍ ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ ଅର୍ ସର୍ଭିସ୍. ଯେମିତି ଏକ୍ଜାମ୍ପଲ୍ ଦେଉଛି, ବିଭିନ୍ନ ପ୍ରକାରର ଏଇଟା ହେଇପାରେ. ଗୋଟେ ଇନକ୍ରିଜ୍ ଭାଲ୍ୟୁ, ଇନକ୍ରିଜ୍ ଭାଲ୍ୟୁ ମାନେ ବାଏ ୱାନ୍ ଗେଟ୍ ୱାନ୍ ଫ୍ରି, ସେଠି ଭାଲ୍ୟୁ ବଢ଼ିଗଲା ବା କ୍ୱାଣ୍ଟିଟି ବଢ଼ିଗଲା, ରାଇଟ୍? ଡିକ୍ରିଜ୍ ପ୍ରାଇସ୍, 50% ଡିସ୍କାଉଣ୍ଟ, ସେଠି ପ୍ରାଇସ୍ କମିଗଲା. ବା କମ୍ବିନେସନ୍ ଅଫ୍ ବୋଥ୍ ଇନକ୍ରିଜ୍ଡ ଭାଲ୍ୟୁ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଡିକ୍ରିଜ୍ଡ ପ୍ରାଇସ୍, ଏଇ ସବୁଗୁଡ଼ା ହେଲା ସେଲ୍ସ ପ୍ରମୋସନ୍ର ଏକ୍ଜାମ୍ପଲ୍. ତ ନାଓ ଲେଟ୍ ଅସ୍ ଡିସ୍କସ୍ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ଡିଫରେନ୍ସ ବିଟୱିନ୍ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ ଆଣ୍ଡ ସେଲ୍ସ ପ୍ରମୋସନ୍. ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ ଇଜ୍ ଅର୍ ଦ ବ୍ରଡ୍ ଅବଜେକ୍ଟିଭ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ ଇଜ୍ ଟୁ ଇନଫର୍ମ, ଟୁ ପରସୁଏଡ୍, ଟୁ ରିମାଇଣ୍ଡ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଟୁ ରିଏନ୍ଫୋର୍ସ. ବଟ୍ ଦ ଅବଜେକ୍ଟିଭ୍ ଅଫ୍ ସେଲ୍ସ ପ୍ରମୋସନ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଟୁ ବୁଷ୍ଟ ସର୍ଟ ଟର୍ମ ସେଲ୍ସ. ଯେମିତି ଯଦି ଗୋଟେ କେଉଁଠି 50% ଡିସ୍କାଉଣ୍ଟ ଲାଗିଲା, ଦେନ୍ ସେଇ ସେଲ୍ର ଯେତେ ପର୍ଯ୍ୟନ୍ତ ଭ୍ୟାଲିଡ୍ ଅଛି ବା ତାର ଯେତେ ଦିନ ଯାଏ ତାର ଡ୍ୟୁରେସନ୍ ଅଛି, ପିପୁଲ୍ ୱିଲ୍ ବି ଏନକରେଜ୍ ଆମେ ସେଇ ଷ୍ଟୋର୍କୁ ଯିବା, କାହିଁକିନା ସେଠି ଡିସ୍କାଉଣ୍ଟ ଅଛି ବା ଗୋଟେ ସେଲ୍ ଲାଗିଛି. ଆମେ ଯେମିତି ଦେଖିଥିବା ଦ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ କ୍ରେଜ୍ ଏଇସବୁ ଫ୍ରିଡମ୍ ସେ କ'ଣ ଇଣ୍ଡିପେଣ୍ଡେନ୍ସ ଡେ ଅର୍ ଇଣ୍ଡିପେଣ୍ଡେନ୍ସ ୱିକ୍ ସେଲ୍, ବ୍ଲାକ୍ ଫ୍ରାଇଡେ ସେଲ୍ ଅନ୍ ଡିଫରେଣ୍ଟ ଅନଲାଇନ୍ ସେଲର୍ସ, ସେହି ସମୟରେ ସେମାନେ କୋଟି କୋଟି ଟଙ୍କାର ଜିନିଷ ବିକ୍ରି କରୁଛନ୍ତି ଗୋଟେ ସପ୍ତାହରେ ବା ଗୋଟେ ଦିନରେ ବା ଗୋଟେ ନିର୍ଦ୍ଦିଷ୍ଟ ଟାଇମ୍ ପିରିୟଡ୍ ଭିତରେ. ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ବିକଜ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ସେଲ୍ସ ପ୍ରମୋସନ୍ ପ୍ରୋଭାଇଡେଡ୍ ବା ହେଭି ଡିସ୍କାଉଣ୍ଟସ୍ ବା ସମ୍ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ଇନ୍ସେଣ୍ଟିଭ୍ ପ୍ରୋଭାଇଡେଡ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଏନକରେଜ୍ ଦ କଷ୍ଟମର୍ସ ଅର୍ ପୋଟେନ୍ସିଆଲ୍ ବାୟର୍ସ ଟୁ ପରଚେଜ୍, ରାଇଟ୍? ଖରାଦିନେ ବି ସିଏ ଆମକୁ ସ୍ୱେଟର କିଣେଇବା ପାଇଁ ବାଧ୍ୟ କରିଦେବ, ଶୀତଦିନେ ବି ଆଇସ୍କ୍ରିମ୍ ଖାଇବା ପାଇଁ ବାଧ୍ୟ କରିଦେବ ଯଦି ଜଣେ ଖାଇବାକୁ ଚାହୁଁନଥିବ. ବଟ୍ ଇଫ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ ଭାଲ୍ୟୁ ପ୍ରପୋଜିସନ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଗିଭେନ୍, ତ ସମ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ନନ୍ ବାୟର୍ସ, ମୁଁ କହୁନି ଯେ ସମସ୍ତେ କରିବେ, ବଟ୍ ସମ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ନନ୍ ବାୟର୍ସ ଯେଉଁମାନେ କି ଚାହୁଁନଥିବେ ଅଦରୱାଇଜ୍ ସେମାନେ କିଣିନଥାନ୍ତେ, ଜଷ୍ଟ ବିକଜ୍ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ସେଲ୍ସ ପ୍ରମୋସନ୍ ପିପୁଲ୍ ମାଇଟ୍ କନ୍ସିଡର୍ ପର୍ଚେଜିଂ, ରାଇଟ୍? ଆମେ ବି ତମେ ନିଜ ହିସାବରେ ବା ନିଜ ଲାଇଫ୍ରେ ୟୁ ମାଇଟ୍ ହାଭ୍ ଏକ୍ସପିରିଏନ୍ସ ଦ ଇମ୍ପାକ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ସେଲ୍ସ ପ୍ରମୋସନ୍. ଆମର ଗୋଟେ ଜିନିଷ ଦରକାର ଥିବ, ଆମେ ଆଉ ମାନେ ତା ସହିତ ଦୁଇଟା ପାଞ୍ଚଟା ଜିନିଷ ବି କିଣିଦେଇପାରିବା ବିକଜ୍ ଦେର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଏ ସେଲ୍ସ ପ୍ରମୋସନ୍. ବା ଦୁଇ ଜଣ ଯଦି ଯାଇଛନ୍ତି, ଗୋଟେ ଗୋଟେ ଫ୍ରି ଅଛି, ସେ କହ ତୁ ଏଇଟା ନେଇଯା, ମୁଁ ଏଇଟା ନେଇଯିବି. ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ କୋଲାବୋରେସନ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ହ୍ୟାପେନିଂ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଏନକରେଜେସ୍ ଅର୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ବୁଷ୍ଟ ସେଲ୍ସ, ସେଲ୍ସକୁ ଇନକ୍ରିଜ୍ କରେ, ରାଇଟ୍? ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ ଅବଜେକ୍ଟିଭ୍ ଅଫ୍ ସେଲ୍ସ ପ୍ରମୋସନ୍. ଦେନ୍ ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଆର୍ ଦ ଭେରି ୟୁ ନୋ ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ସମ୍ ଅଫ୍ ଦ ଭେରିୟସ୍ ସେଲ୍ସ ପ୍ରମୋସନ୍ ଟୁଲ୍ସ, ଯୋଉଟା ହେଲା ପ୍ରାଇସ୍ ଡିସ୍କାଉଣ୍ଟ, ଆମେ ଜାଣିଛନ୍ତି, ଯେମିତି କୁପନ୍, ସ୍କ୍ରାଚ୍ କାର୍ଡ, କୁପନ୍, କଣ୍ଟେଷ୍ଟ, ସାମ୍ପ୍ଲିଂ. ସାମ୍ପ୍ଲିଂ ହେଲା ଯେ ଗୋଟେ ଫ୍ରି ସାମ୍ପଲ୍ ଦିଆଯିବ, ତ ଆପଣ ତାକୁ ବ୍ୟବହାର କରିବେ, ବ୍ୟବହାର କଲା ପରେ ଇଫ୍ ୟୁ ଲାଇକ୍ ଇଟ୍ ଦେନ୍ ୟୁ ମାଇଟ୍ କନ୍ସିଡର୍ ରିପର୍ଚେଜିଂ ଇଟ୍. ସେଠି ସେମାନେ ଦେ ୱିଲ୍ ଟେକ୍ ଇନଫର୍ମେସନ୍ ଫ୍ରମ୍ ୟୁ କି ଏଇ ସାମ୍ପଲ୍ ଯେଉଁ ଆପଣ ୟୁଜ୍ କଲେ, ଯେ ଆପଣଙ୍କର ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ୱାଜ୍ ୟୋର୍ ଏକ୍ସପିରିଏନ୍ସ, ହ୍ୱାଟ୍ ଆର୍ ଦ ପଜିଟିଭ୍ ଆସ୍ପେକ୍ଟ ଆବାଉଟ୍ ଦ ପ୍ରଡକ୍ଟ, ଆବାଉଟ୍ ଦ ବ୍ରାଣ୍ଡ. ଯେମିତି ଆପଣମାନେ ଦେଖିଥିବେ ଡଭ୍ର ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜମେଣ୍ଟରେ ସେମାନେ ଦେଖାଉଛନ୍ତି ଯେ ଆମେ ଚାରି ଜଣ ପାଞ୍ଚ ଜଣ ମହିଳାଙ୍କୁ ନେଲୁ ଆଜ୍ ଭଲେଣ୍ଟିୟର୍ସ ଆଣ୍ଡ ତାଙ୍କ ଉପରେ ଟେଷ୍ଟ କରିକି ଦେଖିଲୁ, ସାତ ଦିନ ଯାଏ ସେମାନେ କୌଣସି ମେକଅପ୍ ଲଗେଇଲେନି, କିଛି ଲଗେଇଲେନି, ବଟ୍ ତାଙ୍କର ଗୋଟେ ସାଇଡ୍ର ଗାଲରେ ଆମେ ଡଭ୍ ଲଗେଇଲୁ, ଆଉ ଗୋଟେ ସାଧାରଣ ସାବୁନ ଲଗେଇଲୁ, ଆଣ୍ଡ ଛୋଟ ଛୁଆ ଯିଏ ଫ୍ୟାମିଲି ମେମ୍ବର ଅଛନ୍ତି ସେ ଦେଖିକି କହିଲେ ଯେ ଯେଉଁ ପଟେ ଡଭ୍ ଲାଗିଛି ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ସଫ୍ଟ ଆଫ୍ଟର୍ ଏ ପିରିୟଡ୍ ଅଫ୍ 7 days ଅର୍ ସମଥିଙ୍ଗ, ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ସାମ୍ପ୍ଲିଂ. ଦେନ୍ ରିବେଟ୍ସ, କଣ୍ଟେଷ୍ଟ, ସ୍ୱିପ୍ ଷ୍ଟେକ୍ସ. ସ୍ୱିପ୍ ଷ୍ଟେକ୍ ହେଲା କ'ଣ? ଇଟ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଅଲ୍ସୋ ଏ କାଇଣ୍ଡ ଅଫ୍ କଣ୍ଟେଷ୍ଟ ଯେଉଁଠିକି ଆମେ ଲକି ଡ୍ର ହେଉଛି, ଆମେ ନିଜର ନାଁ ଫୋନ୍ ନମ୍ବର ଇମେଲ୍ ଆଡ୍ରେସ୍ କିଛି ଗୋଟେ ପକେଇ ଦେଇ ଆସୁଛୁ, ଗୋଟେ ବକ୍ସ ଥିବ ବା ଲକି ଡ୍ର ହଉଥିବ ସେଠି, ତ ସ୍ୱିଫ୍ଟେକ୍ ସେଠି, ତାପରେ ଗୋଟେ କିଛି ଦିନ ପରେ ସେଟା ବାହାରୁଛି, ୱିନର ଆନାଉନ୍ସ ହଉଛନ୍ତି, ଆଣ୍ଡ ବେସ୍ଡ ଅନ୍ ଦ କୁପନ୍ ଆମେ ତାକୁ ଯାଇକି ରିଡିମ୍ କରୁଛୁ। ଦେନ୍ ଲୟାଲିଟି ପଏଣ୍ଟ, ଲୟାଲିଟି ପଏଣ୍ଟ ଯେମିତି ଆମେ ମେନି ଅଫ୍ ଦ ଅନଲାଇନ୍ ୱାଇଲ୍ ପର୍ଚେଜିଂ ଅନଲାଇନ୍ ବା ୱାଇଲ୍ ରିଫୁଏଲିଂ, ଆମେ ପେଟ୍ରୋଲ ପମ୍ପରେ ବା ଫୁଏଲ ପମ୍ପରେ ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ରିଫୁଏଲ କରୁଛୁ, ଆମର କ୍ରେଡିଟ୍ କାର୍ଡ଼ ବା ଡେବିଟ୍ କାର୍ଡ଼ ୟୁଜ୍ କରୁଛୁ, ଆମକୁ ଲୟାଲିଟି ପଏଣ୍ଟ ମିଳୁଛି। ଆମେ ଯଦି କୌଣସି ନିର୍ଦ୍ଦିଷ୍ଟ ସପିଂ ମଲ୍ରେ ଯାଇକି ଆମେ କିଣୁଛୁ, ଜିନିଷ କିଣାକିଣି କରୁଛୁ, ଦେନ୍ ୱି ଅଲସୋ ଗେଟ୍ ସମ୍ ଲୟାଲିଟି ପଏଣ୍ଟସ୍। ସୋ ଦ ଅବଜେକ୍ଟିଭ ଅଫ୍ ଦିଜ୍ ଲୟାଲିଟି ପଏଣ୍ଟସ୍ ଇଜ୍ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ଦେ କିପ୍ ଦ କଷ୍ଟମର୍ସ ଆଚିଭ୍ ମୋର୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ମୋର୍ ନମ୍ବର୍ସ। ସେମାନେ ଆମକୁ ପ୍ରଲୋଭିତ କରନ୍ତି ଅଧିକରୁ ଅଧିକ ଲୟାଲିଟି ପଏଣ୍ଟ ଗେନ୍ କରିବା ପାଇଁ, କାହିଁକିନା ଯେତେ ଆମେ ଯେମିତି ଏଇ ମେଡିସିନ କିଣିଲା ବେଳେ ବି ଆମେ ହ୍ୱାଟ ଇଜ୍ ଦାଟ ମେଡ୍ ପ୍ଲସ୍, ସେଠି ଆମେ ଗଲେ ସେଠି ପଏଣ୍ଟ ମିଳୁଛି, ଯୋଉ ପଏଣ୍ଟକୁ ଆମେ ସବସିକ୍ୱେଣ୍ଟଲି ରିଡିମ୍ କରିଦେଇପାରିବା। ଆମେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଆମର କାର୍ଡ ସ୍ୱାଇପ୍ କରିକି କିଛି କିଣୁଛନ୍ତି, ଆମକୁ କିଛି ଲୟାଲିଟି ପଏଣ୍ଟ ମିଳୁଛି, ତ ସେ ଲୟାଲିଟି ପଏଣ୍ଟକୁ ଆମେ ସବସିକ୍ୱେଣ୍ଟଲି ରିଡିମ୍ କରିପାରିବା ବା ସେଥିରେ ଆମେ ଅଲଗା କିଛି ମାନେ ରୁପି ଭାଲ୍ୟୁ ରୁପିଜରେ ବା କରେନ୍ସିରେ ଆମେ ତାକୁ କନ୍ଭର୍ଟ କରିପାରିବା, ରାଇଟ୍। ସୋ ଏଥିରେ ଆଡ଼ଭାଣ୍ଟେଜ୍ କ'ଣ ନା, ଆମେ ସେଇ ଆମେ ଯଦି ଆମ ପାଖରେ ଚାରିଟା କ୍ରେଡିଟ୍ କାର୍ଡ଼ ଅଛି ବା ଦୁଇଟା କ୍ରେଡିଟ୍ କାର୍ଡ଼ ଅଛି ବା ଦୁଇଟା ଡେବିଟ୍ କାର୍ଡ଼ ଅଛି, ଗୋଟେ ଡେବିଟ୍ କାର୍ଡ଼ ଆମକୁ ଲୟାଲିଟି ପଏଣ୍ଟ ଦେଉଛି, ତ ଆମେ ସେଇ ଡେବିଟ୍ କାର୍ଡ଼ ବା ସେଇ ବ୍ୟାଙ୍କର ସେଇ କାର୍ଡ଼କୁ ହିଁ ୟୁଜ୍ କରିବା, ଆମେ ହୁଏତ ଆରଟାକୁ ବେଶୀ ୟୁଜ୍ କରିବା ନାହିଁ। ଯେମିତି ଆମେ ଦେଖୁଥିବା, ଯେମିତି ଆମେ ଏବେ ବହୁତ ଜଣ ଡିଜିଟାଲ୍ ପେମେଣ୍ଟ ୱାଲେଟ୍ ସବୁ ୟୁଜ୍ କରୁଛନ୍ତି, ବିକଜ୍ ସେଥିରେ ଆମକୁ ସେଇ ଲୟାଲିଟି ବା ପେ ବ୍ୟାକ୍ ଏସବୁ ବା କ୍ୟାସବ୍ୟାକ୍ ଅଫର୍ ମିଳୁଛି ବା ଲୟାଲିଟି ପଏଣ୍ଟ ମିଳୁଛି, ରାଇଟ୍। ଆମେ ଯଦି କୌଣସି ପେଟ୍ରୋଲ ପମ୍ପରେ ସେମିତି ଫ୍ୟାସିଲିଟି ଅଛି, ଦେନ୍ ଆମେ ସେଇ ପେଟ୍ରୋଲ ପମ୍ପକୁ ଯିବା ବା ସେଇ ପେଟ୍ରୋଲ ପମ୍ପ ଚେନ୍କୁ ଯିବା ବା ସେଇ କମ୍ପାନୀର ପେଟ୍ରୋଲ ପମ୍ପରେ ହିଁ ଆମେ ପେଟ୍ରୋଲ ଭରେଇବା ଯେଉଁଠି ଆମକୁ ଲୟାଲିଟି ପଏଣ୍ଟ ମିଳୁଛି, ବା ସେଇ ରିଟେଲ ଆଉଟଲେଟ୍ ବା ସେଇ ମଲ୍କୁ ଯିବା ବା ସେଇ କ'ଣ ଅର୍ଗାନାଇଜ୍ ରିଟେଲ ପାଖକୁ ରିଟେଲର ପାଖକୁ ଯିବା ଯେଉଁଠି ଆମକୁ ଲୟାଲିଟି ପଏଣ୍ଟ ମିଳୁଛି, ଆମେ ସେ ପଏଣ୍ଟକୁ ସବସିକ୍ୱେଣ୍ଟଲି ରିଡିମ୍ କରିପାରିବା। ଯେମିତି ବହୁତ ଜଣ ଏବେ ମେଡ୍ ପ୍ଲସ୍ରୁ ଯାଇକି ମେଡିସିନ୍ କିଣୁଛନ୍ତି, ବିକଜ୍ ସେମାନେ ଗୋଟେ ଅଫର୍ ଡିସ୍କାଉଣ୍ଟ ଦେଉଛନ୍ତି ବା ଲୟାଲିଟି ପଏଣ୍ଟ ଦେଉଛନ୍ତି, ଯଦିଓ ଏଇ କୋଭିଡ୍ ପାଇଁ ହୁଏତ ବନ୍ଦ କରୁଛନ୍ତି ବା ଯାହା ବି। ସୋ ଲୟାଲିଟି ପଏଣ୍ଟସ୍ ଆଜ୍ ଦ ନେମ୍ ସଜେଷ୍ଟ ମେକ୍ସ ଦ କଷ୍ଟମର୍ ଲୟାଲ। ଯୋଉ ମଣିଷର ଲୋଭ ଅଛି ନା, ସେ ଲୋଭ ଚକ୍କରରେ ୱି ବିକମ୍ ଲୟାଲ, ବିକଜ୍ ଇଚ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଏଭ୍ରି ଟାଇମ୍ ୱି ଡୁ ସମଥିଙ୍ଗ। ଯେମିତି ଆମେ ଓବିରେ ବା ଏଚ୍ଆର୍ଏମ୍ରେ ପଢ଼ିଥିବା ଯେ ଯୋଉ ଲର୍ଣ୍ଣିଂର ଗୋଟେ ଏକ୍ସାମ୍ପଲ୍ ଥିଲା, ଯେଉଁଠି ଫ୍ରଏଡ୍ଙ୍କର ଏକ୍ସପେରିମେଣ୍ଟ ଥିଲା ଯେ ଡଗ୍ ଏ ପିସ୍ ଅଫ୍ ମିଟ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଏ ବେଲ୍, ସିଏ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଘଣ୍ଟି ସରି ସିଏ ଯେତେବେଳେ କୁକୁରକୁ ମାଂସ ଖଣ୍ଡେ ଦଉଥିଲେ ସେତେବେଳେ ଘଣ୍ଟି ବଜାଉଥିଲେ, ତ କୁକୁର ଜାଣିଗଲା ବା ସିଏ ଧୀରେ ଧୀରେ ଜାଣିଗଲା ତାଙ୍କର ପୋଷା କୁକୁର ଯେ ଘଣ୍ଟି ବାଜୁଛି ମାନେ ମାଇ ବସ୍ ମାଇ ଓନର୍ ଇଜ୍ ଗୋଇଂ ଟୁ ଗିଭ୍ ମି ଏ ପିସ୍ ଅଫ୍ ମିଟ୍। ତାପରେ ଯେତେବେଳେ ଘଣ୍ଟି ବାଜିଲା ଦ ଡଗ୍ ଷ୍ଟାର୍ଟେଡ୍ ସାଲିଭେଟିଂ, ସେ ପାଟରୁ ଲାଳ ଗଡ଼େଇବାକୁ ଅଟୋମେଟିକ ଲାଗିଲା, କାରଣ ସେ ଜାଣିଲା ଯେ ଖାଦ୍ୟ ଆସୁଛି ବା ସେ ମନେ ପକେଇଲା ଯେ ଖାଇଥିଲା କେମିତି ତାର ଟେଷ୍ଟ ଥିଲା, ରାଇଟ୍। ସୋ ଦ୍ୟାଟ୍ ମେକ୍ସ ଇଣ୍ଡିଭିଜୁଆଲ୍ସ ଲୟାଲ, ରାଇଟ୍। ଦେନ୍ ପଏଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ପରଚେଜ, ପଏଣ୍ଟ ଅଫ୍ ପରଚେଜ ୱି ହାଭ୍ ଅଲରେଡି ଡିସ୍କସ୍। ଦେନ୍ ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ସେଲ୍ସ ପ୍ରମୋସନ, ଏଇଟା ଆମେ ଯାହା ଏଗୁଡ଼ା ସବୁ ଡିସ୍କସ୍ କଲେ, ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ କନ୍ଜ୍ୟୁମର୍ ସେଲ୍ସ ପ୍ରମୋସନ ବା ସି ବି ଟୁ ସି ବିଜନେସ୍ ଟୁ କଷ୍ଟମର୍ ମାର୍କେଟ୍ ସେଗମେଣ୍ଟରେ ଏଇଟା ହୁଏ, ବଟ୍ ଦିଜ୍ ଆର୍ ବି ଟୁ ବି ସେଲ୍ସ ପ୍ରମୋସନ ଟୁଲ୍ସ, ଯୋଉଟା ଆଲାଉନ୍ସେସ୍, ସେଲ୍ କଣ୍ଟେଷ୍ଟ, ପ୍ରାଇସ୍ ଡିଲ୍ସ, ଟ୍ରେଡ୍ ସୋଜ୍, ଟ୍ରେନିଂ ପ୍ରୋଗ୍ରାମ, କୋପରେଟିଭ ଆଡ଼ଭର୍ଟାଇଜିଂ ଏସବୁରେ ହୁଏ। ଯେମିତି ଡିଷ୍ଟ୍ରିବ୍ୟୁଟର ମାନଙ୍କୁ ଥାଏ ଯେ ଆପଣ ଯଦି ଏତିକି ସେଲ୍ସ ନମ୍ବର ଆଚିଭ୍ କରୁଛନ୍ତି, ଦେନ୍ ଫ୍ୟାମିଲି ସହିତ ଫରେନ୍ ଟୁର୍, বা কৌঠি, বিভিন্ন প্রকার অফার থাকে, রাইট? সো দিজ আর দ্য এক্সাম্পলস, আই এম নট গোয়িং টু গেট ডিটেলস অফ ইট, মে বি যদি কাহার কিছু ডাউট থিব আপন মানে মতে পচারি পারিবে, আই উইল বি হ্যাপি টু এক্সপ্লেন অল দিজ। সো উই হ্যাভ জাস্ট ইট ইজ অ্যাবাউট টাইম, সো শ্যাল উই কনক্লুড, লিভ ইট হিয়ার রিমা স্যার? উইল কন্টিনিউ সাবসিকুয়েন্টলি ইন দ্য নেক্সট ক্লাস।
Yes, yes, if contents are there, then we'll continue in the next class.
Sure, sure. Because I don't want to, go beyond the time. And so if there are questions, we can take up those questions.
Again, I request all those learners to ask any question. You can unmute your mic and you can ask the question directly to our resource person. I assume
so
that
do there we are, have any questions?
I assume that there are no questions. So thank you so much, Dr. Anshuman Jena, for sharing your
hello, sir.
For your for your deeper thoughts. And
hello, sir.
Yes.
Hello, sir. Yes, sir. There is a question, sir. Please, what is the difference between advertising and promotion? There is a question, sir, please.
Yes, yes. This is a question from Gokul Dandasena. Yes, this is a very good question. The basic difference between sales promotion and advertising is in their objective. Takara objective hi different. Advertising ba advertisement ra objective hela to inform, to persuade, to remind and to reinforce. It are mostly brand building ba image building ba positioning opare our objective thai advertising ra. Sales hela secondary ba tertiary objective of advertising. Advertising ra brand building is the prominent objective of advertising, but when it comes to sales promotion, as the name suggest, sales promotion ra objective hela to boost or to enhance short term sales. Sethi brand opare hue to negative impact padi pare. Jemti mu example douchi, ame situation bhabiba, gote brand jota Apple re kebe apno buy one get one free paibeni. I am talking about Apple iPhones or Apple products, Apple INC, মো আপল এজ ফ্রুট কহুনি, রাইট? সেটি সেটি সেমানে জানিছন্তি যে পিপল দে ডোন্ট নিড দ্যাট কাইন্ড অফ সেলস প্রমোশন বা এ টাইপ্র ব্র্যান্ডর যদি এটি ডিসকাউন্ট অফর করা যিব, দেন ইট মাইট ক্রিয়েট এ নেগেটিভ ইম্প্যাক্ট অন দ্য কাস্টমার্স। লোকমানে একু খারাপ পাইবে, লোকমানে ভাবিবে যে এটা বিক্রি হউনি বলি এটা ডিসকাউন্ট দৌছন্তি, রাইট? যেতে লক্সারি ব্র্যান্ড, যেতে পপুলার ব্র্যান্ড, দে মোস্টলি ট্রাই টু অ্যাভয়েড দিজ শর্ট টার্ম টেকনিক্স। বট আমি যদি বহুত গুড়ে অলগা কোম্পানি কথা ভাবিবা, বর্ষ তমাম সেটি সেল লাগি থাকে, রাইট? আউ সেমানে বা সেমানকু লোকমানে এতে সম্মানর সহিত সে ব্র্যান্ডকু দেখন্তি নাহি, দে ডোন্ট লাইক দ্য ব্র্যান্ড জস্ট বিকজ লোকমানঙ্কর দে গেট দ্যাট ইম্প্রেশন কি এটা বিক্রি হউনি বলি তাকু এতে সময় মানে এটি বর্ষ সারা সেল লাগিছি, বা লোক দেখিবে সেমানে কিনিবেনি, কইবে হ এটা তো বর্ষ সারা সেল লাগিছি, এবে এটা ননেলে হব, আর সপ্তাহকু আসলে বি সেই অফার থিব, আমি সেতেবেলে কিনিবা, রাইট? সো দে আর দ্য বেসিক ডিফারেন্স ইজ ইন দ্য ভেরি অবজেক্টিভ অফ advertising and sales promotion. They try to achieve two different things. Advertising through re brand image, brand ra gote unique position create kariya pai objective thai. Sales promotion re खाली प्रमोशन अलग सेल्स प्रमोशन अलग प्रमोशन माने आम कहले प्रमोटिंग द कंपनी प्रमोटिंग ब्रांड आम इंटीग्रेटेड मार्केटिंग कम्युनिकेशन माने प्रमोशन रो अर्थ कम्युनिकेशन बट सेल्स प्रमोशन इज ए स्पेसिफिक टूल ऑफ मार्केटिंग कम्युनिकेशन एडवर्टाइजिंग गोटे जमती सेल्स प्रमोशन सेमती तो सेल्स प्रमोशन रो ऑब्जेक्टिव हला सेल्स बढ़ेवा किंतु जदि एटा वर्ष तमाम एटा सेतिपई कहला डेफिनेशन रे जे इट इज ए शॉर्ट टर्म टूल इट कैन बूस्ट सेल्स फॉर ए लिमिटेड टाइम पीरियड किंतु जदि एटा वर्ष तमाम रहिला इट विल क्रिएट ए नेगेटिव इंपैक्ट ऑन द ब्रांड और इट माइट क्रिएट ए नेगेटिव परसेप्शन इट वर्ष सारा सेल अछि इट किछि ताने बिक्री होउनी बाकी नौ नांदी तेन करी एटा पड़िछि राइट सो दिस बा बहुत जन लोक जो माने सेल रे किणंती तांकु भी किछि जन लोक माने कोन टिके नेगेटिव बा टिके लो दृष्टि रे देखंती जे जोटी सेल लागिला ये आगे दौड़ी पळेब किणिया पई right so that kind of perception is there I'm not going to comment whether it is correct whether it is wrong but yes people think this way and that is the broad difference of advertising and sales promotion and that is mostly what they try to achieve tankar objective hi alga and based on that their application and implications are also different I hope I have clarified your doubt
thank you dr chenna gokul is there any questions please raise gokul you can unmute your mic okay gokul has written as no so again thanking dr ansuman chenna for sharing deeper thoughts about promotional strategies and its implications it was really absolutely enlightening session for those marketing students so the leftover part will be covered in the later class future classes it will be notified accordingly so I am thanking our technical support Mr. Amit as well as our resource person Dr. Ansuman Jena so this is we come to the end of this class so thank you so much and have a good day
thank you